Nydia Tisdale.
Nydia, I need you to go right there. Are you this way, ma'am?
Yes.
If you raise your right hand, please, do you swear or affirm that the evidence you shall give before this court is a matter of the state of Georgia versus Nydia Tisdale, will be the truth, the whole truth, and nothing but the truth, so help God?
I do.
And if you would have a seat, make sure you speak into the microphone so that everybody can hear you, the court reporter can take down what you said, right? So tell us your full name, please.
Nydia Pinzón Tisdale.
And Ms. Tisdale, what is your occupation?
I am a citizen journalist, although that is more of an avocation than a vocation.
What is your vocation, then?
I have some investments and some real estate that I manage, and I have some rental properties.
All right, but you also consider yourself to be, as I understand it, a citizen journalist, correct?
Yes.
And would you tell us what a citizen journalist is?
Well, for lack of a better term, it's not a real reporter. I've never called myself that or a real journalist, but a citizen journalist is one who attends public meetings of public interest and records them for the public to see. That is what I do as a citizen journalist. I provide information for the public to, I'm sorry. I provide information for the public to learn more about their local governments. As a citizen journalist, that's what I do.
And how do you do that?
I video record meetings of public interest with public officials.
Okay. And is it generally public events?
Indeed, yes. I only go to public events and I post them on my YouTube channel.
So if you go to public events, and when you go to public events, how do you record them?
With a video camera.
And is it your video camera?
Yes.
And when you record those events, is your video camera handheld, or is it stationary, like the TV cameras?
I use a tripod, and I also handhold my camera. I do both. It depends on the situation and what is more effective.
Do you generally, when you record these public events, do you generally ask questions or participate at all in the event, or just record the event?
Generally, I stay behind the camera. I don't engage because it's too difficult to multitask for me.
So the answer is no, I don't generally ask questions or participate, but I just record, correct?
Yes.
And then you post them on social media, correct?
Yes.
And what type of social media do you post them on?
On YouTube, and then I link the YouTube video to Facebook and Twitter and on my website, which is called aboutforsyth.com.
Aboutforsyth.com? You can speak up just a little, you're fading.
Sorry.
You're fading, okay. And I want to make sure everybody hears you. How long have you been doing this?
I've been doing citizen journalism for about 7 years, but I've been video recording public meetings for about 5 years.
Okay. And when, in the course of doing this, have you had the occasion to videotape public meetings, county meetings?
Yes.
Have you had the opportunity to videotape political meetings and rallies?
Yes.
Have you had the opportunity to videotape and post other types of public meetings, like zoning or hospital or other types of public meetings?
Yes.
And have you had the occasion in the past to videotape and post political rallies that include, for example, the governor of the state of Georgia?
Yes.
Various other public officials like the Secretary of Agriculture, the Secretary of Labor, the Attorney General?
Yes.
and those types of public figures at public events, correct?
Yes, correct.
Had you, in fact, recorded a number of public figures prior to August of 2014?
Yes.
Okay. And do those include the governor?
Yes.
And at that time, who was the governor?
Nathan Deal.
And the attorney general?
Sam Owens.
Right, and so the answer is yes. And the attorney general was Sam Owens?
Yes.
Okay. You had recorded both of them previously, correct?
I have recorded, actually, let me rethink that. I have filmed both of them multiple times. And I believe in August of 2014, the first time I filmed the attorney general was, I was hoping to film him that day, but I was not allowed to film him. So I have filmed him, yes.
And other public officials at other political rounds, correct?
Yes.
Citizen journalism, using the video camera, have you been recognized by any associations or groups or gotten any awards for your citizen journalism?
Yes, I have.
And would you tell the court about that, please?
In 2014, I received a Democracy Award from Common Cause Georgia, and in 2015 I received a Open Government Hero Award from the Georgia First Amendment Foundation.
And you,
pardon this part of the scene.
Give me a minute first. A couple of photographs. See if you can identify those for us, please.
The first photograph is myself and Sean McIntosh, who is the president of Georgia First Amendment Foundation, and also I was receiving an award in 2015. And the second photograph is me receiving an award from William Perry of Common Cause Georgia in 2014.
All right, I'm going to mark the first one as defendant's exhibit number one. And that's the award that you got from?
From Georgia First Amendment Foundation.
Okay, what's marked as defendant's exhibit number two is getting the award from?
Common Cause Georgia.
Judge, I move the admission of defendants number one and number two.
No objection.
Admitted.
And when I get done with my hand off to you.
Right.
How do you, and I'm sorry, I didn't mean to turn my back to you, but there's not enough room up here. I have my photographs here. So if I turn my back to the court and ask a question, I apologize to you too. When when you determine where you're going to go to film as a citizen journalist, how do you do that?
A variety of ways. Sometimes I will be asked to attend a specific event and asked to video record. Oftentimes I'll learn about an event via social media, from Facebook, in my newsfeed, or from Twitter. I'm very active on social media, so things will appear, and people will often invite me to events as well.
So you can find out about political events from, for example, let's say the internet, like Google and other sources, correct?
Correct, yes.
Social media, Twitter, and other.
Correct, and let me add also, from government websites, I can find out when there are city council meetings and county commission meetings from the calendar and the public notices.
And as well as other public sources like newspapers, correct?
Correct.
So any public source is something that you keep in touch with in order to make a determination oh, I think I'll go to that place, I think I'll go to that now. It's a long question.
Yes.
Okay. Let me get to this particular event. Did it come to your attention that there was going to be a political rally at Burt's Pumpkin Farm on August 23rd of 2014?
Yes, I learned about it on Facebook.
Did you also learn about it from other public sources?
No, I learned about it directly from Facebook. It was in the news feed, and I joined the event. It was.
And let me hand you what's marked as defendant's exhibit number 3. Did you see that before?
Yes, I saw that before.
And is that on a public source?
Yes.
And is it advertising or announcing the rally at Burt's Pumpkin Farm?
Yes, it is.
Just let me.
Is that exactly what it looked like?
Yes.
Okay.
Yeah.
Okay.
Let me move to event exhibit number 3. And since we don't have the overhead, can I give it to the witness and ask some questions?
You bet.
And if you don't mind, can I stand over here?
You bet.
I'll try not to block you or the court report. You know, I get some dispensation if you're over 60 and you can't figure out how to use these things. Yes. We are discussing for the record defendant's exhibit number 3, okay? Say yes.
Yes.
So you gotta speak up.
Yes.
You just nod your head. That young man right there can't take down a nod. Well, he can't. We'd rather have a yes or no for the record, okay?
Yes.
And that was an announcement, was it not, talking about the Dawsonville rally, correct?
Correct.
And it was on an internet, an open source internet, correct?
Correct.
Right. Yeah, available to any member of the public.
Yes.
And that's where you saw.
Yes.
And it announced the rally at a certain location, and that was at Burt's Pumpkin Farm, correct?
Yes.
Is that what's on defendant's exhibit number 3?
Yes.
Right. And did it also announce who was sponsoring that rally?
Yes, it reads hosted by Nathan Deal.
Okay. And there were also other politicians there, correct?
Yes. Yes.
And who are the other among the other politicians or candidates at this particular point? This was an election, correct?
Correct.
And this was on a run-up to the election, correct?
Correct.
And Governor Deal was running for another term, correct?
Correct.
And a number of the candidates there were running for office.
Yes.
So this was a political rally, correct?
Yes.
And it was in an ongoing election season, much like we're in right now.
Yes.
And did this announce, among others, who would be at that rally?
Yes. It listed, would you like me to read the list?
Sure.
Also attending, Sam Owens, Attorney General of Georgia, Gary Black for Agriculture Commission of Georgia, Insurance Commissioner Ralph Hutchins, Mark Butler for Labor Commissioner. Further down the list, which is not on this, is Richard Woods, who was running for school superintendent, and as well as candidate for U.S. Senate at that time, David Perdue.
Okay. Was there anything at all in this post or on defendant's exhibit number 3 that required a sign-up? In other words, did you have to sign up to go?
No.
Was it advertised, at least in this source, as open to the public?
Yes.
Were there any restrictions noted in the advertisement not the advertisement, the announcement on Defendant's Exhibit 3?
No.
Were there any restrictions as to who could come?
No.
What party they had to be?
No.
That they had to sign up and get approved by anybody?
No.
That they couldn't bring cameras or other recording equipment?
No.
As far as Defendant's Exhibit 3 is concerned, it was a open to the public political event, correct?
Yes, and public has a little globe icon, which means it's open to anyone in the world, anyone on the planet.
Where there were there other sources that you saw after you saw that this rally was going to be taking place that announced the event?
Yes.
I'm going to hand you Defendant's number 4.
This is an advertisement that appeared in a newspaper, and to my knowledge, it appeared in the Dawson News, and it is the legal organ of the county.
Okay. And did you see that item?
Not in advance of the event, but afterwards, I did discover this.
And did you see it in its original form?
I saw it like that.
Okay. And is this, where did you see it?
It was sent to me as an email attachment.
Okay.
From someone who had clipped it out of the newspaper.
Okay. So your understanding is it came from the newspaper and it's a true and accurate copy of a newspaper advertisement for this event, correct?
Correct.
I tendered that Defendant's Exhibit number 4.
Mm-hmm. Yes.
Again, I'm going to stay up here, Judge. Now, this was a advertisement that appeared in a local newspaper, and it is for the event at Burt's Pumpkin Farm, correct?
Correct.
And it announces a political rally, correct?
Correct.
And it is it public? Would you describe it as a public invitation?
Yes.
Would you like me to read it or?
Well, it's in the record. We can talk about it.
Absolutely.
At the outset, in big letters, it says, "Please join us for a visit with the candidates," essentially, right?
Yes.
Okay. And at the bottom, does it contain any language at the bottom?
Yes, it reads, the event is free and all are welcomed and invited to attend.
So the public, in general, with no restriction whatsoever, was invited to attend the event, correct?
Correct.
Were you, and did you ever see any restrictions like you got to pay admission, you can't come in without a ticket, or anything like that?
No.
Did it say press is not welcome?
No.
Cameras aren't welcome?
No.
Any restrictions whatsoever to the vast majority of the world coming in?
The only restrictions I saw were no guns and no pets.
We're talking about this advertisement.
No, there were no restrictions on this advertisement.
All
forgive
right,
me.
We'll talk about the other moment. Judge, I'm going to hand up Defendant's Exhibit number 4. I'm going to hand you what's marked as Defendant's Exhibit number 5. Can you identify the second?
It's from the long minute.
Okay, don't touch it, it's the long minute.
Okay, yes.
Yeah. Can you identify that for us, please?
This This is from the Delonica Nugget, and at the bottom of the page, there is an advertisement for this same event.
And that's from the newspaper itself, correct?
Yes, correct.
All right, that's a true and accurate copy of the advertisement that appears in the newspaper?
Yes.
You have written of defendants, exhibit number five, please, Jim.
No objection, Your Honor.
Once again, does it also say that this advertisement, number five, does it indicate who was one of the sponsors of the event?
It reads, "You're cordially invited to meet Governor Nathan Deal and David Perdue." And the sponsor, forgive me, the Lumpkin County Republican Party would like to announce.
Okay. And what they would like to announce is the political gathering, correct?
Yes, correct.
And they were announcing it for Burt's Farm, correct?
Correct.
Did that public advertisement in the newspaper have any restrictions on who could come, on what they could bring, on who could come?
No.
On what they could bring?
No.
Who was invited and who was not invited?
No.
Did it say Republicans only?
No.
So even if you're a dreaded Democrat, you could appear and show up and listen to what candidates say in public?
Yes, all were welcome, yes.
All were welcome?
Yes.
Didn't restrict it as to party, age, gender, religion, and the fourth estate or anything like that, right?
Correct.
Okay. Judge, I hand up defendant's exhibit number five. It did say, if you want more information, there was a person to call.
Yes, it reads, contact Clinton Bearden, and it provides a phone number and an email address for more information.
Okay, for more information, but not any restriction in the advertisement itself.
No restriction whatsoever.
So if you didn't want any information from Mr. Bearden, and you had enough information in the advertisement itself, you could just show up, as far as you understood, correct?
Correct.
And up defendant's exhibit number five. Now, prior to the time that you went to this rally, and we'll talk about the rally in a minute, did you have the opportunity to look up the location?
Yes, I did look up the location.
Okay, and the location was Burt's Farm?
Yes.
And Burt's Pumpkin Farm is a popular tourist attraction, correct?
Yes.
I mean, it has an internet presence, doesn't it?
Yes, burtsfarm.com.
Okay, but it
yes.
has an internet presence. And on the internet, there are a number of written items, correct, about the farm.
Yes.
There are a number of pictures of the farm.
Yes.
There are some policies that are on the internet and available to the public about the farm. Correct?
Yes.
And it appears to me and to you, did it appear to you to be a popular tourist location and well attended by tourists and locals alike?
Yes, indeed. It looked like a very inviting, fun, family-friendly place.
And based upon what you saw and what you heard, did you make a decision as to whether or not you were going to go to Burt's Pumpkin Farm?
Correct. Yes, I did.
Okay. Now, when you were looking at Burt's Pumpkin Farm's website, was there anything at all indicating a restriction on photography or videotaping at all?
No.
And was there anything on the website that in fact encouraged taking pictures and videoing the surroundings and the family and others? That might be
as a tourist attraction, in my opinion, they are in the business of selling memories, and what better way to capture that with a camera?
Okay. So there was nothing on, and no policy or otherwise, that indicated that you couldn't film a purpose, right?
No, and in fact, I found multitude of videos of Burt's Farm posted on YouTube, and lots of pictures of Burt's Farm posted all over social media as well. It does seem very popular.
It wants to have a big presence and draw in people, correct?
Correct, yes.
I'm going to hand you what's been marked as Defendant's Exhibit 6. What's marked as Defendant's Exhibit Number 6, okay? Do you recognize that?
Yes.
And can you tell the court what that is for?
This is a page from Burt's Farm website, and it has some information regarding visitor information, visitor hours, guest policy, and field trips.
And was there any policy that you saw on the Burt's Farm website that prohibited taking photographs or videos?
No.
Was there any source prior to the time that you arrived that day at Burt's Farm that indicated to you that anyone would be prohibited from either taking pictures, videotaping the event, or recording the event?
No.
I'm going to hand out Defendant's Exhibit Number 6. All right, tell us a little bit about the morning or the day that you went to Burt's Farm.
It was on a Saturday, and I live in Roswell, and it's a long drive to Burt's Farm, and I map-quested it, and I had printed out the directions, and went early so I could find my way. I'd never been there or to that part of the state previously, and I was really looking forward to seeing the scenery, and it was a beautiful drive up. And I arrived early at the same time as David Perdue's sister, Debbie Perdue, and we met in the parking lot, and we both came in. And
was it your decision to go to the political rally to film the rally?
Yes.
In your capacity, as you have done many times in the past, as a citizen journalist, correct?
Yes.
So you went there with the object of recording what you understood to be a completely open public forum with political candidates, correct?
Yes.
And so when you arrived there, you parked and you had your camera with you, correct?
Yes.
Right. And you always take your camera with you, don't you?
Almost always, yes.
I mean,
correct.
It's almost an appendage to your hand.
Yes, I've been filming for over 25 years. I've always had a camera pretty much.
And on this particular day, you didn't, at least when you first arrived, you didn't have a tripod, correct?
I had brought a tripod, and when I discovered that the floor, the ground, was an uneven surface, I realized it wasn't going to work, so I returned the tripod to my vehicle in the parking lot, and then I came back, and I have a miniature 6-inch tripod, which attaches to the bottom of my camera, so I used this little baby tripod just to hold the camera steady, and I was holding it by hand.
All right, so there was an attachment of about 6 inches to the camera, correct?
Yes.
So that you can hold the camera, and you either hold it up or hold it to the side, and almost like what I guess it's known now as kind of a selfie stick, but just a short one.
Well, I don't normally turn it back on myself, but yes.
I know that, but that kind of item with the camera on top of it, correct?
Yes, correct.
Okay. And was that the camera that you had with you
Yes.
And when you first arrived, you indicated that you That you talked with Mrs. Purdue?
Ms. Purdue, David's sister.
David's sister, okay. Or Senator Purdue's sister.
Yes, and I had met her previously at other campaign functions.
Okay, had you previously recorded now Senator Purdue at other political functions?
Yes.
And other political functions that were open to the public?
Yes.
Did you have your camera in hand when you talked to Ms. Purdue?
I had it in my camera bag on my shoulder, yes.
Was there any indication from Ms. Purdue that you couldn't use your camera?
I'm going to object to that. Any indication, hearsay, any statement, any acknowledgement of what Ms. Purdue said or did not say or did not indicate, you know, on that witness stand.
Except for this goes to her state of mind. And I mean, either the rules of evidence apply. This is a 104 hearing. I'm unsure as to whether the rules of evidence apply or not. Under 104, the rules of evidence don't apply to preliminary hearings. Hearings such as suppression hearings and others. Now, the question is, does it apply to immunity hearing? I've seen nothing, and I don't know whether it does or not, but generally speaking, under Rule 104, the rules of evidence don't apply to pretrial determinations that are made to the court. So one, my answer would be the rules of evidence don't apply. If you believe that they do and you're going to apply them, then her state of mind is directly at issue. And whether it's for the truth of the matter asserted or not, it's not admitted for the truth of what she heard or didn't hear, but to show her state of mind and course of conduct. So it's an exception to the hearsay.
The rules that don't apply, then you're doing sequestration of evidence because we're not having a formal
I think an immunity hearing is a different animal than other pretrial motions.
Okay.
I mean, it's basically a mini trial. And so I'm confident that the intent is for rules of evidence to apply. However, you know, I'll sustain the objection as to the truthfulness of any. Although I don't think you asked for statements, I think you asked for, what was your question?
Well, the question was, did Ms. Purdue at that particular time, or anybody connected with Senator Purdue, indicate that you couldn't film? And that's not for the truth of the matter, sir, but to show her, of course, the conduct.
Well, that limited question.
Okay.
No, there's no indication that recording was not allowed. And in fact, I had filmed multiple times and I was familiar with Ms. Purdue and commented how much fun these rallies are. And I said, I enjoy them. And she said, well, you should. You come to enough of them.
Right. So your understanding, you got no other understanding at that particular time that filming or recording was prohibited.
Correct.
Okay. And after you talked with Ms. Group, what did you do? By the way, about what time did you arrive? Do you remember?
I believe the rally started at 3:30, my memory serves me, and I arrived probably close to 3 o'clock. I got there really early because, again, I didn't know my way. I wasn't sure exactly how long it would take. And I wanted to get some pre-shots of the venue. So I walked around the barn and the facility and took a few shots of the sign and the structure and, you know, as an introduction to my video.
And when you say I wanted to get some pre-shots, that would be filming, correct?
Yes.
And that would be filming the venue, you said?
Yes.
And the venue would be the location, correct?
Yes.
And just how it looked?
Yes, to give a time and place of venue to the video, the context to the video.
I'm going to introduce this and hold it on. I'm going to play it along and ask her questions about it. I don't see any other way to do it. I wouldn't push it.
Yeah, that's Judge, by the way, did you record that event?
I did record that event.
Okay. And was your camera in working order at that time?
Yes.
And have you seen a complete copy of your recording?
Complete? I don't know if it is complete.
What you've been provided, what's in your camera, have you seen a recording of that?
I have watched the footage that's available on my camera, yes, correct.
And indeed, have you posted that to social media?
Yes, it's available on YouTube.
Okay. And you've seen that, correct?
Yes, I have.
And you've seen a copy of it, correct?
Yes, I have.
And Judge, I'm going to mark with the permission of the state, I'm not going to mark it now, but I'm going to introduce this CD as a, and you've seen it, correct?
Yes.
On your YouTube page, correct?
Yes.
And it's a true and accurate copy of what you had and posted on your YouTube, correct?
Yes, correct.
I guess the next number is 7. Do I know if I'm going to wait until after I play it to put the sticker on it?
No objection, Judge.
By the way, does your camera also have audio?
Yes.
So it's got audio and video, correct?
Yes, correct.
But which direction does the microphone?
I have a directional microphone as an attachment. Yes, correct.
All right. And that is a sign indicating where you are, right?
Yes, correct.
The location. And just as a companion, I'm going to introduce some stills. And this is going to be defendant's exhibit number 8, Ms. Lane. And is 8 a still that was made from the video that you took that day?
Yes, it is.
And that number 8 just shows what's on the screen now that we stopped, correct?
Yes, it does.
All right, and it shows the location.
Right? Yes, it reads Burt's Farm, Dawsonville, Georgia, which is a sign over the barn as you entered the venue.
Okay, and I'm going to move to admit that that is number 8. No objection. Now, defendant's number 8, then you pan out, is that what it's called? Pan out.
Or zoom out, zoom in, zoom out.
Zoom out, okay. And I've stopped here and I'm going to mark defendant's exhibit number 9. This is a accurate copy still from the front of Burt's farm, correct?
Yes, it is.
All right. I'm going to hand you number 9. And is that taken from the video that you prepared?
Yes.
In that day?
Yes.
Now, is that the front of, I guess, the entrance into where this round came up?
This is the entrance to the venue, and there was a meet and greet inside the barn area in advance.
Is that the location in which you go into the event?
Yes.
Are these signs depicted in both the video or the CD? And the still, are those the signs that were visible and apparent that day?
Yes.
And did they include political signs? Like, you can see Gary Black signs, Sam Olin signs, correct?
Yes, correct.
Did any of these signs or any sign that you saw prior to you taking a picture of the venue from the outside indicate that press wasn't allowed?
No.
That citizen journalists weren't allowed?
No.
That Democrats weren't allowed?
No.
That there had to be permission or an entry fee into the venue?
No.
Did any of the signs say no videotaping allowed or no filming allowed?
No.
Okay. So, Judge, I moved, I guess, 89.
Yes, I shot it twice because I'm using my, holding it by hand to get a smooth shot. Sometimes I'll film something multiple times to get a good shot.
We're going to just play it. Okay, and on the screen now, of course, is the Stars and Bars, right?
Yes, it is our American flag.
Sure. And it was prominently displayed there as well, correct?
This isn't, yes, it was, in a different building, a different structure, but at the same venue.
All right. Well, in any of the other buildings or structures, were there any signs that prohibited your attendance?
No.
Or journalistic attendance?
No.
Or prohibited attendance or limited attendance by anyone?
No.
And we saw pictures of one. You say this is a different location. Were there any signs in a different location?
Not pertaining to photography, no. There were signs elsewhere, yes.
Pertaining to photography and who could come to the rally?
No, not.
Were there any signs in this building that pertained to who could come to the rally and what they could do there?
No.
In any other building that you saw, that you may or may not have photographed or videoed, were there any signs prohibiting who could come and what they could do?
No.
Now what's shown there?
This is a pickup truck with two campaign signs, one for David Perdue and one for Nathan Deal. There's some hay bales in the back of the bed. And that was, lack of a better terminology, that was the stage where the rally was to take place.
Okay. All right, now, would you describe what was on the screen now?
This is the RV bus for the David Perdue campaign.
And this is in the parking lot, I'm assuming.
Yes, it is.
It's not inside the venue yet.
No.
Right. But were you familiar with this campaign bus?
Yes, I had, in fact, filmed the kickoff rally of this campaign bus when it first embarked on its statewide tour.
Okay. And clearly, you were filming this particular bus.
Yes. the arrival of the candidate, him alighting from the bus.
As you intended to film the candidate?
Yes.
Okay. And again, did you have your little stick on your camera at that time, or just have it on your wrist?
Well, both. I have two hands, and I have the strap holding attached to one hand, and my hand holding the tripod. So yes, I'm holding my camera by hand.
And when you hold it, do you hold it out in front of you?
Well, it has a flip-out viewfinder, so I'm looking at that, so I have to position it. Yes, I do hold it in front of me.
Okay, yeah, you don't hold it behind you.
Of course not.
You don't hold it out to the side necessarily. Sometimes you might, but generally speaking, you hold it in front.
Yes, sometimes I may hold it up here if I need to as well. I hold it in front of me, yes.
And when you are filming, it's visible, correct?
Oh, yes.
And if one is looking at you, one can see you filming, correct?
Oh, certainly, yes.
And was that the way that you were filming this particular arrival in this scene that we see on the sentence exhibit?
Yes.
All right. And that's it. Sorry, you didn't stop it soon enough.
Purdue, and her name escapes me at the moment. I don't know the gentleman with the glasses.
And who was that that just got off the bus?
That was then candidate David Purdue.
Okay, and he had just got off his bus.
Yes.
You were filming him.
Yes.
Did it appear to you that he looked directly at you in the camera?
Yes, and we recognized each other because I had filmed him previously.
Yeah, sorry, we just have water. Yeah.
Yes.
And again, he was walking in with others associated with him, correct?
Campaign staffers, yes, correct.
And he was he not, according to the advertisements that we've already introduced, public postings, he was one of, going to be one of the featured speakers, correct?
Yes.
Okay. He walks into the venue and you're filming, as we see here, correct?
Yes.
That's the same entry that we talked about earlier.
Correct, yes.
There's nothing posted about who can come. There's no table outside prohibiting people from coming in, correct?
Correct.
There's no entry fee that's required to get in, correct?
Correct.
Was there any sign-up table that you saw inside or outside?
Well, when you say sign-up table, they were asking people to sign if you wanted campaign information from particular campaigns, but no sign-up to attend the venue.
Yes, that's correct. Now, Senator Perdue is a tall guy.
Very tall, yes.
Right. And you're not so tall.
I'm 5'6".
So you're not so tall.
I am not so tall.
Right. Not as tall as the candidate, correct?
Correct.
And why I mention that is because in order to get it in even on shot, you have to hold the camera up.
Yes, I extend my arm and hold the camera as high as I can.
And was that what you were doing at this particular time?
Yes, you can tell by the angle that the camera is above everyone's heads.
Now, you're following the camera in, correct?
Correct.
You're following the candidate in.
Yes.
My apologies. And you're filming, correct?
Yes.
Right. And you're clearly filming because you have your camera up above your head at that particular time, right?
Yes.
Now, the candidate seems to be stopping and greeting several people there on the right.
Yes.
Okay. And you can see over the shoulder of the guy in the blue shirt.
Yes.
See the guy in the blue shirt there? The dark blue shirt.
And the dark hair?
Yes. I don't know if you can see this. Right there.
I do see him, yes.
Okay. Now, over his right shoulder is a young lady, correct?
Yes. Yes.
And who do you know that to be?
Mrs. Kathy Burt.
Okay. So did it appear that candidate Perdue was stopping to greet the Burts?
Yes.
Well, he's Kathy Burt from this particular vantage, correct?
Yes.
Now there is a person to the left of candidate Perdue. Can you see that?
I can see, yes.
And do you know who that person is?
Yes.
And who is that person?
Mr. Johnny Burt.
Okay. And when you were filming this, did you have your camera up?
Yes, it was elevated.
Directly at you and your camera?
I believe that Mr. Burt for both. Yes. I believe that at different times, both Mr. and Mrs. Burt did see my camera.
For example, in this photograph, or this still on part of this video, both Mr. and Mrs. Burt are the attacking candidates for you in your film, correct?
Correct.
And you're filming and holding your camera up, correct?
Correct.
Did it appear to you at that time that Mr. Burt looked directly at the camera?
Yes.
Let me hand you what is a still
Yes.
Mark this as Defendant's Exhibit Number 10. And in that still, does it appear that Mr. Burt is looking towards you and the camera?
Yes, it does. That is the daughter of Mr. and Mrs. Burt, and her name is Casey Sanders.
Okay. Today we really.
Restate your question.
While you were coming in and after you were filming candidate Purdue, and the shot stopped, right? Did you have an opportunity then to talk with Mr. or Mrs. Burr?
No, I did not.
You never talked with them at all?
No, I spoke with Mrs. Kathy Burt when I first arrived and after I greeted Debbie Purdue in the parking lot.
Okay, and where did you talk with Mrs. Burr?
At about the same location that Mr. Purdue was speaking to Mrs. Burt at the entrance of the barn.
Okay, and that was before you were filming?
Yes, when I had first arrived.
And could you tell us the nature of that exchange?
I had my camera back on my shoulder. I wasn't filming yet. I hadn't taken it out. She introduced herself and said, I am the property owner. My name is Kathy Burt, and her daughter was standing nearby, and her son-in-law was standing nearby, and another person, I assume a guest, I don't know who the other person was, and she offered me pumpkin bread and pumpkin pie, and she was very gracious, very warm, very welcoming. She directed me to the ladies' restroom, and just full of Southern hospitality. She was actually very polite.
Okay. Was there any interchange about who you were, what you were doing there, why you were there?
I introduced myself as well and told her, I'm Nydia Tisdale, I'm a citizen journalist. I video record public meetings of public interest, and I will record today's rally. I also shared with her that I had filmed Governor Nathan Perdiel earlier.
Nathan Deal?
Sorry, thank you for correcting me. Governor Nathan Deal. Earlier in the month, in August, 3 weeks earlier, at a similar rally in the city of Roswell, where I live. And the only candidate missing from that rally was Attorney General Sam Owens. And I came to Burt's farm with the hope of video recording Mr. Owens that day.
Okay. So, as I understand it, you and Mrs. Burt had a conversation.
Yes, we did. I also shared with her that the video that I would be filming on that day would be available on YouTube, as was the previous video I had filmed earlier in the same month.
You shared with her who you were. Is that correct?
Yes.
What you were there to do.
Yes.
That you had done it before, correct?
Correct.
That you had videotaped the governor before, correct?
Correct.
And that you had posted your videos on social media, correct?
Correct.
Did Mrs. Burt, did you tell Mrs. Burt that you were here with any political campaign or on behalf of any candidate?
No.
Did Mrs. Burt inquire of you whether or not you were here with a particular candidate?
No.
Did you advise Mrs. Burt that you were there just as a citizen journalist to take and record the entire event?
Yes, I did.
Okay. And at that time, did Mrs. Burt or any other person tell you, no, it's our policy that you can't film, or that no filming is allowed, or no photography is allowed, or no recording is allowed?
No.
And based upon your conversation with Mrs. Burt, did you have any reason to believe that you would not be allowed to record the event?
No, not at all.
Okay. Now, between the time that we saw you filming candidate Perdue and the Burts were right there, did anybody say anything to you at that particular time? What are you doing recording? We don't want any recordings here.
No, other than the introduction with the campaign staffer for David Perdue asking if I was press.
Okay. But I mean, at the time you were walking in, we saw you walking in, that's where we are in terms
Thank
of
you.
Time now, okay? When you were filming, and we introduced into evidence stills of Mr. and Mrs. Burt, correct?
Correct.
And you walked right up to them filming?
Yes, I did.
And they were looking at you, at least you believe and understood they were looking directly at you per the exhibits, correct?
Yes, correct.
Okay. But did either of them, or any candidate, or any person at that time, say you can't come in here and record?
No.
Did anybody say you can't videotape?
No.
Did anybody say, hey, what are you doing with that camera, lady?
No.
Okay. You shut the camera off. You didn't video record anymore at that particular time, correct?
Correct.
All right. How long was it between when you shut the video camera off at that particular point in this next scene where we're starting?
A very short period of time. I believe people were waiting for the arrival of Mr. Perdue and Mr. Deal. and I wanted to get down and secure my seat, so I walked around the building to get to where the rally would be held.
Okay, so how much time elapsed between when we just saw you?
A minute or two.
Couple of minutes, 5 minutes, 4 minutes?
A few minutes, yes.
Okay, it doesn't have to be exact, just because, yes.
Okay.
You were keeping the time clock, right?
Correct.
Now, when you film, where do you usually attempt to film from?
It varies on the event and if there's a designated area for video cameras. Sometimes it's the back of the room, sometimes it's the very front of the room. It just depends on if there's any guidance for that. I prefer being closer to the front of the room because I can get a better video and it's a clearer quality.
Okay. In this particular instance, what we're talking about, and a stopped screening here, this person on the screen first, did that person introduce himself?
No.
Have you subsequently come to find out who that person is?
Yes.
Okay, and who is that person that we see exhibited on the screen now?
Clint Bearden.
Okay. Now, did you start filming as soon as the rally started, or the event started?
Yes.
Okay. So tell us where you are.
I'm in the front row. At the center aisle on the right-hand side, if you're facing the speaker.
Front row, right-hand side. Now that's right-hand side facing the speaker, correct?
Correct.
Right. Once again, you told us you didn't have a tripod, right?
Correct.
Right. But you were holding the camera in your hand, correct?
Yes.
About how far away were you from speaker at this particular point?
I'm not a good judge of distance, but very close. Very close. Perhaps, yes.
Okay. The other people on the front row, were there other people sitting on that front row?
I don't know because I wasn't looking on either side of me. I was focused on my camera and the speaker. And I can't speak to that. I'm sorry.
All
right. I appreciate having you here at Burt's Farm. I think we're ready to get this show on the road today.
I'm sorry. I wanted to explain that people were arriving and had not taken their seats yet, so I don't think anyone was seated in the front row. I don't think many people went and sat down. Yet. They were in the process of taking their seats.
Okay. Would it be fair to say you got up front so you could get a good spot so that you could get a clear picture?
Correct, yes.
And was there anything obstructing your view?
As people were taking their seats, people were walking in front of my camera, so yes, there was an obstruction.
But there was no physical impediment, there was no column, there was nothing of that nature.
Correct, no.
And you were as close as the seating allowed to the candidates, correct?
Yes.
And while it wasn't on a tripod, the camera was visible to anybody who was looking, right?
Yes.
Okay. Now, in this particular still, who do we see over there on the right?
We see Congressman Doug Collins and Attorney General Sam Owens.
Okay.
Everyone that you came to see, I let them start talking and kind of give you an update about the strong Republican ticket that we have this year. Just very quickly, want to give extra special thanks.
And, you know, some guy just walked in front of the camera, right?
Right, and he shrugged his shoulders almost as an apology.
Sorry.
Yes, correct.
Now, Mr. Bearden here, he's looking at you, it looks like.
Yes.
In this still right here, doesn't it? Has he said anything to you about any policy or anything that would prohibit you from filming at that point?
No.
Has any other candidate, for example, Representative Collins, Attorney General Owens, or any of the other candidates there, said anything to you about not filming?
No. No. Well,
at that point,
no one, but I had spoken with Attorney General Sam Owens earlier. And I told him I would be filming the rally, and he said, I figured you would. I had tagged him on Twitter and on Facebook, and he expected me to be there because of those tags on social media.
What do you mean by tag?
When you post on Twitter, you can include another person's Twitter account, and they'll get a notification that you've been tagged in a tweet, and similarly for Facebook as well. So I tag every single candidate in my tweets and on Facebook. I've promoted the event on social media. I also tagged Mr. Johnny Burt's Twitter account at that time.
Prior to the time of you going in, we just saw Attorney General Owens. Had you said you talked with Attorney General Owens?
He arrived early. He was one of the first candidates to arrive, and we had a brief conversation, yes. Yes, he shared some really wonderful news with me about a court case that he had filed on my behalf against the city of Cumming and its mayor, H. Ford Gravett, regarding a lawsuit that the state filed because I had been ejected for video recording a city council meeting, and that was a violation of Georgia Sunshine Law.
So you and Attorney General Owens had a conversation prior to the rally starting and prior to you setting up?
Yes, correct.
In fact, somebody took a picture of you and Attorney General Owens, correct?
Yes, Mr. Brian Pritchard with Fetch Your News took our photograph.
Let me hand you what's been marked as evidence exhibit number 12. Recognize that picture?
Yes, I do.
And does that picture truly and accurately represent the scene that day as you were having your photograph taken with Attorney General Owens prior to the time that you went in?
Yes.
Okay. I'm going to move Defendant's Exhibit 12.
Move the issue.
Amen.
Now, I just asked about getting your picture taken with Attorney General Owens.
Yes.
That wasn't a selfie, right?
No.
It was taken by someone else, correct?
Yes.
And I think you identified that person as Brian Pritchard.
Yes, correct.
And Brian Pritchard is who?
He is a journalist, and he has a website called Fetch Your News. He's an editor and owner of Fetch Your News.
Does he also have a radio show?
He does now. At that time, I don't think he had it yet.
Okay.
But it's a morning show 5 days a week, I think from 8 to 11.
Is it an ad?
I'm sorry. Forgive me.
Okay. Did he have any radio show at that time?
Not to my knowledge, no.
But he was a journalist, correct?
Yes, sir.
And he took your picture, correct?
Yes, upon my request.
Mr. Pritchard have a video camera to your knowledge?
He was using what you would consider a still camera, a DSLR. However, most cameras have both functions, where a video camera can take still images, and likewise a still camera can take video. And most anyone who has a cell phone can take still pictures as well as video.
Okay. But he had a camera that he was using, correct?
Yes, he did.
He was a journalist as well. Right?
Yes, he is.
Did he also have recording equipment?
Yes, he did.
Was it your understanding that he was intending to take pictures and audio recorded the event?
Yes.
And to your knowledge, did he do so?
Yes.
And to your knowledge, did he capture both audio and still photographs of the event?
Yes, he did.
Like the photograph introduced as defendant's exhibit number 12, correct?
Yes, correct.
Okay. And you've seen those, correct?
Yes, I have.
And we'll talk about a few of those in a few minutes, but as far as this is concerned, where was Mr. Pritchett after you sat up on the front row and were visibly photographing the introductions here at?
He was on the third row on the left-hand side of the center aisle.
Okay, so you were on the right with your camera. He was on the third row on the left.
Yes.
Was there anything, did you see anybody sitting in front of him?
Not at that time, no.
Did he have his camera up?
Yes.
To your knowledge, was he taking pictures at that time?
Yes, many pictures.
Okay. And were you also taking pictures?
I was only taking video.
Video. Sorry. But you were also taking videos, correct?
Yes.
And was he, to your knowledge and observation, recording as well?
I was not aware that he was recording at that time, but I afterwards found out that he was audio recording.
Okay. And if you had the opportunity to listen to his audio recordings?
Yes, I have. Yes.
Okay. And they're true and accurate recordings of what occurred that day, correct?
Yes, correct.
Okay, we'll get to that in a few minutes, but let's get a move in order here.
As a always, to Johnny and Kathy Burt, the entire Burt family, for allowing us to have this event here at Burt's Farm, for all the hospitality that they've extended, so thank you.
Now, we see the angle shift, correct?
Yes.
Tell us why the angle shifted at that point.
I stand up from the seat on the right-hand side, and I cross the center aisle, and I sit in the left-hand side because people were still arriving and taking their seats, and I didn't want them to walk in front of my camera.
Okay. And when they were arriving, and presumably some of the people that were arriving were the candidates, correct?
Correct.
Or the speakers, correct?
Yes.
Because we still see, even in this little shot here, the still shot on the screen, Sam Owens over there on the right?
Yes.
Who's that guy he's talking to, do you know?
I'm over 50, so I have to wear my glasses.
Pardon me.
That is Governor Nathan Deal.
Okay, so you get up, you physically stand up from the right-hand side. You've got your camera with you.
Yes.
All right, we haven't had a speaker yet. Mr. Beard, who you now know is Mr. Beard, is still introducing and thanking folks for the event, correct?
Correct.
You stand up and you walk across holding the camera, correct?
Yes, filming Mr. Burton, correct.
Okay. But you walk from right to left.
Yes.
And once again, I guess I've already used Ray Charles, we'll go with Helen Keller. could have seen you filming and walking across and taking a position on the left-hand side, right?
Correct, it was very obvious.
Right, and it's right in front of Mr. Beard.
Yes.
Right in front of the candidates, Candidate Owens and Candidate Governor Beal, correct?
Yes, correct.
Okay. Now, where did you sit when you get over there to the left?
Again, in the front row, on the center aisle, but on the opposite side.
All right. And behind you now is Mr. Pritchett, correct?
Yes, correct.
So you're both on the same side?
At that point, yes.
All right. He's still taking pictures.
I'm sorry. I've done one enough. Objection, you've got it on the right and he's left. I'm going to argue. We go with something Donald Trump would say 95% of the time, which is accurate, Helen Keller saying. He has it on the right. He's leading just about every question.
Well,
I'm sorry.
You know, it's a pre-trial hearing, and I guess you could separate from the chat, but I'll try to do that. To your knowledge, was Mr. Pritchett still taking pictures and recorded.
Again, I didn't know that he was audio recording at that time, but yes, he was still taking pictures.
Okay. And now he was behind you. Was he now behind you?
Yes, he was directly behind me.
Very much to Johnny and Kathy and the entire Burt family. It's really an honor. You know, this is something that many of you that are here were here 5 years ago in August of 2009 when Congressman Deal was running for governor. So it's really great to be here 5 years later and obviously helping to work reelect him to a much deserved
Can you see? Who do you see over there on the right?
Governor Deal and Attorney General Owens.
Second term, so we're glad to have everyone here today. One quick note of announcement, they do have pumpkin pie, pumpkin rolls, and lots of drinks, so help yourself to that. There are restrooms at the end of this building if you need to use the restroom. And then as you came in, y'all may have seen that gigantic pumpkin that was out there. That's the door prize for today. So after the governor speaks, before everyone leaves, we'll announce who's the door prize winner. Somebody's going to get to take home a giant pumpkin because it wouldn't be a pumpkin farm without a giant pumpkin. So with that, I'm going to turn it over to our insurance commissioner, Mr. Ralph Hudgens. We're really glad to have Commissioner Hudgens with us today. He's done a great job on the ballot this fall, and we'll let Commissioner Hudgens go from there. Thank you, sir. Thank you very much. Thank you for being here today. Thank you for helping us re-elect the complete Republican ticket. I tell you, for the first time ever, we've got a Republican in every office, and we need to keep it that way. In the insurance world, like this one tried to do. You know, the Brett.
Judge, with the permission of the state, I'm going to skip a little bit forward because now we have several minutes of the candidates' speeches. But again, during the speeches, or the starting of the speeches, where did you remain seated?
In the front row at the center aisle.
Were you continuing to video and audio report?
Yes.
At that point, had anyone come to you or said anything about not being allowed to do that?
No.
Okay. And we're some minutes into the, how many minutes about are we into the speeches?
Maybe 5 minutes, I'm not exactly sure.
Now, did there come a time when candidate Hudgens mentioned videotaping?
Yes.
Pass out, and I thought I was going to absolutely puke listening to her. I mean, I don't know why you're videotaping, but yes, I said that. So, anyway.
All right. Candidate Hudgens said he was listening to, Shell Dunn?
Yes.
Did he acknowledge you videotaped?
Yes, he pointed at my camera.
And looked right at you and commented towards you, did you not?
Yes, he did.
Okay. Did anyone at that particular time say anything?
No.
Did you hear any laughing in the background at his commentary?
Yes.
You could hear it on the exhibit, right?
Yes, he got a good laugh from his comment.
Do you recall? Do you recall who the second speaker was?
I believe it was Richard Woods, the school superintendent candidate.
And is that a picture of Mr. Wood while he was speaking? That's still?
Yes, it is.
Okay. And you remember who the third speaker was?
Labor Commissioner Mark Butler. And yes.
And on the screen now, is that the candidate, Phillip?
The candidate for Labor Commissioner, yes.
Yes.
Mark Butler, yes, correct. That is him.
Okay. So we had how many speakers? That's a window's fault, that was my fault. How many candidates had come up and gone during this particular period?
Three.
Were you still located in the same place?
Yes.
To your knowledge, was Mr. Pritchett still behind you?
Yes.
To your knowledge, was Mr. Pritchett still behind you taking pictures, and now you know audio recording as well?
Yes.
They gave me enough link here to work with. I like to move around. Y'all excited about this election?
Yeah.
All right, we need you to be. This is a very important election. Yep.
Now, up until that time, had anybody come to try to talk to you about whether or not you could record?
Yes.
All right, let's go back.
Reported him, but Richard Woods is our the candidate for school superintendent, and let's give him a warm Dawson County welcome.
All right. Now, this is at 10:55 on your video. There is a gentleman, I guess, there with a Yale hat on, clearly.
Yes.
And he is in your picture.
Yes.
Okay. Now, did this gentleman talk with you at all about your recording?
Yes, he did.
Okay. And what was your understanding of what he said?
My understanding was that.
What your recollection?
He recognized me from recording the Roswell rally 3 weeks earlier, and that they had asked others to not record, not video record, and they had sent others away, and I did not see anyone else with a video camera, so I don't know that to be true or false, but he said, because we've asked others to leave and not film, it would be fair to let you remain and film, and he said you can either stop filming or leave.
Okay, and did you reply to him?
I did. I explained that I had already spoken with the property owner, Mrs. Kathy Burt, upon my arrival. I had spoken to a couple of the candidates, Sam Owens and David Perdue, and that no one had objected to my video recording the rally.
Okay. Say anything to you about the property owners wanting you to leave?
No, not at all.
Or that is that the entire conversation?
To my recollection, yes.
Okay. And did that gentleman then leave?
I asked him to go check with the previously mentioned individuals, and he did get up and leave, yes. He sat down next to me, in the empty seat next to me,
okay,
when he spoke to me.
Well, we can't hear that conversation, can we?
No, with my directional microphone, it magnifies the sound in front of the camera and minimizes the sound behind the camera. You can maybe hear some whispers, but it's not really discernible.
Now, did there come a time that an individual did, another individual did come up and talk with you about recording?
Yes, and when the first individual came, it was when they traded microphones and they switched from the first speaker to the second speaker. And then at the next break between speakers, another individual came and sat down next to me as well.
Well, who know 10 people. And so we have to get that message out that we have the best plan and we have the best organization for us. And now I'd like to introduce our current and our next Commissioner of Labor, or Secretary of Labor, Mark Butler. So again, appreciate that.
I don't think they gave me enough.
Was it right around that time?
Yes.
Okay. And who was it that came to speak with you at that time?
I did not know who the person was. He was the person that kicked off the rally, the MC of the rally, but I did not know his name at that time. Okay. And it was Cliff Beard.
But you now know it's Mr. Beard, right?
Yes.
It's the person that we saw who didn't identify himself at the beginning of the rally.
Correct.
Do you understand that Mr. Burt, that Mr. Beard had any connection to Burt's farm?
No.
Did you know whether or not he was an employee or otherwise a representative of Burt's farm or Mr. and Mrs. Burt?
No.
Had you at that particular time asked a question? Say anything or ask
questions
to any of the candidates?
No, I was video recording. I can't multitask. I don't ask questions while I'm filming.
So, no?
No, I did not.
All right. Did you do anything other than what we saw you walking from right to left and sitting there holding your video camera?
No, I didn't do anything other than that.
So you didn't say anything? You didn't yell? Did you do anything else?
No, I just sat silently holding my video camera.
Now, when the second person and you were talking about the person, Mr. Beard, what did he come up? Where was he? Where did he come up to?
He came and sat down in the empty seat, the same seat that the previous person sat down. He was on the left-hand side, and I think he was helping MC the event. But he was standing where the speakers.
Where was he?
He was standing towards the front on the left-hand side.
Where was he when he came up to you?
He sat down on my left-hand side.
Okay, so he's sitting to your left, correct?
Yes.
You can't see him in the video camera.
No, you don't see him in the video.
Did you hear anything that he says in the exhibit?
It is muffled, but you do hear some sound behind the camera, some conversation, but it's not really discernible.
Right. So you can't tell that what somebody is saying, correct?
Correct.
Right. That's Link here to work with. I like to move around. Y'all excited about this election?
Yeah.
All right, we need you to be. This is a very important election. Got a lot to talk about. First of all, I've got to give everybody a kind of example about the difference between a Democrat-run Department of Labor and a Republican run Department of Labor. When I got there...
Now, if it was during the exchange of microphones, you've already passed that point, correct?
Correct.
And now, this is the second person again that's talked to you, correct?
Correct.
What did that person say to you?
He made a similar statement that you have to stop recording or leave, and he claimed that there was a policy of no video recording. He said, we have a policy, without identifying we.
Okay. So the second person came up. He sat to the left of you. He said, you got to stop filming. Is that correct?
Yes, that's correct.
And the convention
Yes, he claimed there was a policy.
Had you seen any policy?
No, I had not.
Had any policy been shown to you?
No.
Did any policy, I don't know whom, but any policy at all, had you seen it on the internet?
No.
Had you seen it on any social media?
No.
Had anybody told you earlier that there was a policy of whomever, either the Republican Party or Burt's Forum, Republican Forum, about any policy?
No.
And did you respond to Mr. Beard?
I did, yes.
And how did you respond to Mr. Beard?
Similarly as I did to the first individual, explaining that I had spoken with the property owner when I arrived, and Mrs. Burt and candidates, and no one objected to me being reporting. And I asked him to go confirm my statements, and I gave him names of individuals to speak with.
Well, for example,
Governor, I'm sorry, I misspoke. Attorney General Sam Owens and Senate candidate David Perdue.
Did you tell them about Mrs. Burt, about your conversation with Mrs. About your conversation with?
Yes, I also added Mrs. Burt that I had spoken with the property when I first arrived, told her I was going to be filming, and there was no objection, and she said okay.
Did you request a copy of or to be provided with any policy with regard to?
Yes, when he claimed there was a policy, I responded, show me the policy. And at that, he left.
We had a very, very bloated Department of Labor. We had what I thought was way too many employees. So we said, you know what? The people elected me to give you efficient government. And we've done that. We've reduced our workforce, not positions, that's the difference. Some people are tricky with that. I'm talking about people there. We've reduced our position concentrating on getting people a job, not an unemployment check. Because that's putting them in direction. Well, let's talk about that really quick. Not more about it in just a minute. But let's just talk about this latest little bump in the unemployment rate.
Yes, I do.
Did there come a time when there was a third time that people came to talk to you about filming?
Yes.
Okay. You know, little Mr. Carter, he is very upset right now about the unemployment rate. He's very concerned about the job loss.
Now, I can see the camera shake a little at that point. Had somebody come to talk to you at that point?
I was filming and holding my camera, yes, and someone came and spoke to me.
Saying over the last 3 months.
Was,
and guess what? He's not telling you the whole story. Anybody like to guess which private sector has lost jobs over the last 3 months? That's not private sector. You thousand jobs lost.
What is your name?
Sorry.
Yes, which private sector has lost jobs over the last 3 months? That's not private sector. You pretty much answered.
Yeah, here we are at 1657. 16 minutes of filming. What's happening here?
A hand is in front of my lens.
Yeah. So I said, you'll give him a sandwich. He really is breaking. He's got to go. Greg's got to pick up his son at his work at school. I feel so comfortable waiting for him. But it's not bad.
Thanks, Jason. You have the order?
First exhibit is.
Do you recognize them?
I do recognize them, yes, right.
Do those photographs accurately reflect you filming the candidates, the candidate before candidate four and candidate four?
Yes, it's candidate Woods.
Woods.
And then candidate Butler. I'm sorry, you're not doing that.
But it accurately shows you holding the camera and how you are holding the camera and filming at that time, correct?
Yes, correct.
You didn't take those pictures, did you?
No, I did not.
Do you know who took those pictures?
Yes.
Who?
Brian Pritchard.
Okay. And he was the person sitting behind you?
Yes.
And those do, in fact, accurately represent the way that your camera was being held while you were filming the candidates, correct?
Correct, yes.
Did I move 13, 14, and 15?
Any objection?
No objection.
Amen.
All right, now, we're here. If somebody comes up and puts their hand over the camera, correct?
Correct.
Right. How many people came up to you at that time?
Two.
Right. And where, to your knowledge or recollection, were they?
Behind me and to my left, sort of in my blind side, back here.
Could you see who it was that came up?
No, I did not know who it was.
Where were you looking?
I was looking at the candidate and that might be Hunter.
Okay. Did either of those people sit in the seat to your left?
No.
Like they had previously done?
No.
Did either of those people identify themselves?
No.
Could you tell who they were without seeing them?
No.
When they first came up, what was the first thing that happened?
Someone said, the property owner does not want you to record.
Okay.
No. And may I explain? At that time, I was unaware that there were two people that approached me. I thought it was a single person and one of perhaps the people that had approached previously. I did not know yet that there was a second person.
But a person said that to you?
Yes.
Could you see who that person was?
No.
Did you recognize the voice of that person?
No.
Okay. Had anybody prior to that time said to you, the property owner doesn't want you to record?
No.
All right. And after that was said to you, how did you respond, if at all?
I did not respond.
Okay. And then what happened?
There was a palm in front of the lens, as you can see here, and a voice said, all right, you're leaving, in a very aggressive, hostile
voice. It has not been me.
And I didn't know if it was the same voice that had spoken previously.
Okay. Was there, to your recollection, any other conversation at that particular time?
No, I was not, did not even have a chance to respond. There was no conversation, no.
That was my next question was, how long between the property owner doesn't want you to record and okay, you're leaving, how long was that?
Almost instantaneously. I mean, it was just really quick that I just didn't know what was going on.
Okay. Did you say anything prior to the time that the hand came over the camera as we sit at all? Did you even say anything?
No.
Okay. In private sector job loss. The job loss comes from 45,000 job.
Okay, so what's happening here? Who do we see right there on the left?
He is former Dawson County Sheriff's Office Captain Anthony Wooten.
Okay. And you know that now?
Yes, I did not know that at that time.
And had you seen him prior to the time? Well, what's happened? What's he doing?
He has grabbed my hand and lifted me up out of my chair and pushed and pulled me, and he forces me out of the rally.
Okay, but at this particular point, this is at the beginning, is this at the beginning of that process?
Yes.
Okay. Had you seen the person that was physically handling you prior to that person physically handling you?
I can't speak to that because I didn't see him and I didn't get a good look at him. I had no idea who it was.
Right. So no, you hadn't seen that person. Right.
Not to my knowledge.
Judge, let her answer the question.
Sustained. Thankfully, you win.
Yes. You hadn't seen who it was.
Objection.
Had you seen who it was that was grabbing you?
I did not know who was grabbing me, no.
Had you seen who it was that was pulling you out of the chair?
No, I did not know. I did not see.
Did that person identify himself?
No.
Did that person say the property owner wants you to stop filming?
Not to my knowledge, no. I did not hear that from that person.
Did anybody say, I am the representative of the property owner?
No.
Did anybody indicate to you that they had the authority from the property owner to tell you anything?
No.
That's
what
lost.
Is your name? What is your name? What is your name?
Now, why were you asking him or this person what his name was?
Because I wanted to know who he was and try to identify him and figure out what he was he doing and why. I had no clue who this person was. I didn't get a good look at him. May I explain a little further about my vision? When I wear my
prescription glasses. It's a trifocal lens. And I don't have good peripheral vision at all when I'm filming and I have my glasses on. So he and the second person, which I didn't know at the time was the second person, were in my blind side. So no, I did not see him. I had no idea who he was, and I wanted to know.
Did that person, when you were asking him to identify himself, did he identify himself?
He did not. Sir, what is your name? What is your name, sir? Identify yourself. What is your name? What is your name? Let go of me. What is your name, sir? Let go of me. I spoke with the owner prior to the match beginning. No, Mrs. Burt, Kathy Burt said it was okay. Mrs. Let go of me, sir. Mrs.
Where were you going, what we just heard? Where had you been, and where were you going?
I had been at the rally where the speakers were giving their campaign speeches, and I was being forced up into the barn area where people arrived at the beginning. Yes.
To your knowledge, was there someone else that was also taking pictures of you being taken from a location you told us to another location?
Yes.
And who was that?
Mr. Pritchard.
Okay. And exhibits, I think, 16 through 18, is that right? 19?
Through 19.
Through 19. Do they accurately reflect you being hauled off to another location?
Yes.
To move the admission of 16 through 19.
Admitted.
In objection, sorry.
During this event, at the time that you were taken from one location to another, had anybody identified themselves at that point? To you?
No. No.
At any time during that event, did you when somebody grabbed you, this person grabbed you, and you were being hauled off, what were you doing?
Sitting silently, video recording the speakers.
While you were being taken away.
What was I doing?
Yes.
I was trying to film the person who had grabbed me so that I could later perhaps identify him. I was reaching my arm out, turning my camera around to try to capture his image. And also to keep my camera out of his reach, I didn't want him to damage my gift from my husband, my video camera.
Okay. Were you fighting him?
No, I wasn't fighting him.
Were you kicking him?
No, I wasn't kicking him.
Were you elbowing this person?
No, I did not elbow him.
You know,
this person physically, I guess the word would be manhandling you?
Yes, he was very aggressive, and he was spinning me around.
As shown in those photographs?
Yes, and eventually got my arm twisted behind my back and frog marched me, which was a new word to my vocabulary. I had never heard of that previously.
What kind of shoes did you wear?
Strappy sandals.
Okay, soft sandals or hard sandals?
They're, I don't know how to describe it. I mean, it's a hard sole, but.
Let me hand you what's been marked as defendant's exhibit 20.
Yes.
Do they accurately reflect the shoe wear that you were wearing?
Yes.
At the time that this occurred?
Yes.
Would the admission of those three exhibits?
Can I just?
Yes, sure.
Flash them real quick. No objection.
Stills from my video.
Okay.
Yes.
What happened to those shoes?
They were destroyed.
And how were they destroyed?
The straps came out from the soles and the tips came off of the heels.
Right now, we are at 1736. And where are we now?
This is entering the barn where the giant pumpkin is.
Would that be the giant door front?
Oh. Yes, correct.
I need to show you my name.
Now, did the person right there, did you hear him say you're going to jail?
I'm sorry, you'll have to replay it. I missed that. Inside the barn, not too far from the front door. This is, I think, a shirt.
I know that's a shirt.
Okay.
I got that one.
Inside the barn?
Inside the barn.
Yes.
How were you, where were you inside the barn?
I've been real nice. Now you're going to go.
inside the barn, near the entrance, near a counter where there was campaign literature displayed.
Okay, and where were your arms? How were your arms?
One was twisted behind my back, and the other was holding my camera.
Which hand do you usually hold the camera?
My right hand.
All right, so which hand was behind your back?
My left hand was behind my back.
So someone, this person, had taken your arm and put it behind your back, correct?
Yes.
The other hand was holding on to your camera.
Yes.
Okay.
Resist arrest. You must come.
Please.
And I guess at that point, I heard you resisting arrest, right?
Yes.
All right. Is that the first time that you understood you were being arrested?
Yes.
Okay. And that you were resisting arrest?
Which, that's what he stated, yes. But I wasn't resisting. I was just trying to free myself. He was grabbing me.
Okay, well, what do you mean he was grabbing?
He grabbed my arm and twisted it behind my back and was pushing me, and he was just very forceful and very violent.
Okay, and when you say how he was treating you, where were you physically at this particular point?
Close to the countertop, close okay. to the counter.
And were you being directed in some particular direction?
He slammed me against the countertop and bent me over at my waist. So my face was down up against the countertop, and my camera's still recording, but it's, you know, just all over the place at that point.
Well, you're holding on to it, right?
I'm still holding on to it, yes.
And so you still have it in your right hand? Do you still have it in your right hand?
Yes.
Okay.
Stop, man. We're asking the motion.
To help get people here. So I am the chair. I am sorry that people are treating you this.
Who was that?
Her name is Linda Clary Umberger. At that time, she was the chair for the Dawson County Republican Party.
And this is while you were in the barn, correct?
Yes.
Okay.
Wait, this is wrong. This is wrong. Then I have to stop. Stop.
Understand me? Do you know what I'm saying?
I'll
be happy to. So you stop. Stop.
I'm not being happy to serve you.
She's literally not trying to
work with you. I talked to her.
I spoke with several candidates and they didn't mind. I spoke with the owner. I spoke with Kathy Burt.
Listen, I'm the owner and I said no.
Mrs. Burt said me that it was okay. Kathy Burt said it was okay. I spoke to her when I first arrived. I spoke with Kathy Burt and she said it was okay.
And then I come spoke with you because your owners did not want you to do that. You can record all you want, that's fine. And then you resisted. And then you resisted.
All right, did he say to your knowledge that third time, he, that person that was just, did he say the owners don't want you to record? Do you know?
I don't know.
Did you know whether he indicated to you, did anybody indicate to you that they were the authorized representative of the property owners?
No.
Did they identify, anybody identify themselves as law enforcement?
No.
In fact, you kept asking him. Did you keep asking them to identify themselves?
Continuously, yes.
The more than you fought with me.
I didn't fight with you. You're the one who has grabbed me. Public event posted on Facebook by Governor Deal. This was a public event posted on Facebook by Governor Deal.
Yeah, see, Is that person holding your arm or shoulder or what?
Yes, he has my arm twisted behind my back, and he has my wrist in one, his left hand, and in his right hand, he's grabbing my upper arm and digging his fingers into it, into a pressure point. It was extremely painful.
And is this while you were bent over the bench?
Yes, I was pushed up against the countertop, and he pushed his groin into my backside while I was against the countertop.
And were you able to even move?
No, the countertop did not budge.
This was a public event posted on Facebook by Governor Deal. Kathy?
You just talked to the owner who asked you to leave, who's told you you couldn't do this here, and you're still
okay, leaving. I'll leave.
No, you're leaving. Now you're going to jail. You resisted me, my lawful duties, trying to get...
So, did you hear Mr. Burt at that point say to you, I'm the owner, I don't want you filming? Not
well,
that exact moment,
he said, I said no. I'm the owner,
said no.
I said no.
Right. All right. And then you responded by saying, okay, I'll leave.
Yes.
But of course, this is at a time in which you are already been told that you're under arrest, correct?
Yes.
Okay.
And you to cooperate, you didn't want to do that. You fought with me, you wrestled with me, so we're just going to wait until you're going to
represent me. Did you follow him?
I think he said fought rather than follow.
Did you fight with him?
No, I did not.
Hell, I don't know what else to do with you. I tried to talk
okay.
to you, I tried
please,
to explain
please loosen
no.
your grip, I'm not going anywhere.
As soon as you decide to act like you're somebody and stop fighting with me.
I'm sorry, sir, what did you say?
So as soon as you stop fighting with me,
I'm not
calm
fighting,
down.
I'm not resisting
now, you. You're not now, because I'm not giving you a choice anymore, but you fought me the entire way over here and continued to fight with me. I don't know you, I don't know what you have on you, and I don't like it when I tell you to stop doing something and you continue to do it. I don't know what you have in that
I don't know you you're, either. You have not given me your name, sir.
And I'll be happy to. You'll sit on the
board
when
we
get to jail.
Tell me your name, sir, and show me your badge.
You've seen my badge.
No.
Had you seen his badge?
No, I did not see a badge.
Did you know his name?
No, I did not know his name.
Did you know his whatever authority you may have claimed prior to the time that you were grabbed and taken to another location?
No, I had no clue.
I haven't actually.
Yes,
I didn't.
Yes, you.
And he indicated to you that you would see his name on the warrant, correct?
Yes.
You did not see.
Yes, you have.
Please, sir. Play
stop out. Resisting. You keep saying you're being nice for your camera. Stop resisting.
Mrs. Burtz, I spoke with her in
come
advance.
In.
I told her I was.
Come in.
Here I was. I have
just
my camera on.
Owner of
film.
The place.
What happened there?
Ow!
What happened there?
He grabbed my camera out of my hand and wrestled it. He pulled it off of my hand.
Okay, and was the camera still going?
Yes, at that point it was.
And you were, was that you yelling?
Yes.
And what were you yelling about?
I was yelling in pain and in agony. He was hurting me. He was inflicting harm to my body. It was excruciating. I've never felt anything like that in my entire life.
It hurts. You're hurting me. Wow. You're hurting.
Is that you?
Yes, it is.
Advising this person who still hasn't told you who he was.
Correct.
He was hurting, correct?
Yes.
Stop. You are really hurting me.
Stop.
You are hurting me.
All you gotta do is be still.
And that's it. Right.
All you gotta do is be still. While he had me pushed up against the countertop with his crotch pushing against my buttocks.
Objection, not responsive. I'm not sure that was the question.
sure there was a question.
Pardon me. What was the question?
Good question. Well, I think the question was, that's you, young viewer.
Yes, they were my screens. Those were my screens.
So I'll ask the next question. Why were you screened?
He was hurting me.
In what position did he have you?
He was frauderizing me. He was pushing his body into my body up against the countertop, which would not move.
At the end of what is recorded, correct, by you?
Yes.
Is that right?
Yes.
I've got this. I'm just going to label it. Do you want to use it?
May. And if you can label it, so if you don't mind, I'll put it off. I'm just going to switch out.
After the filming stops, what happened?
Eventually, two sheriff's deputies arrived in two separate vehicles. Dawson County Sheriff's Office vehicles, and when the sound of their tires hit the gravel drive, that is when Captain Wooten stepped away from my body at that time. And when they entered the barn, the two sheriff's deputies, I asked him again, "Who are you?" And when the other deputies were within earshot, he responded, "Captain Tony Wooten, you are under arrest."
Okay. And were you taken somewhere?
I was handcuffed, and I was put in the back of a patrol car, and I was taken to Dawson County Jail.
And were you booked in Dawson County Jail?
Yes. The events started at 3:30, and I'm not sure what time, it might have been an hour later, 4:30. And when I bonded out of jail, it was a little after midnight, and it took me a few hours to make my way home, to retrieve my vehicle and get home with the bonds laid.
So you were in the jail for at least 6 hours?
Yes, at least.
Okay. And did you have to post bond?
Yes, I did.
Now, your video camera captured some of the events.
Yes.
Did your video camera capture all of the events?
No.
Did, were there... You know, we saw you being taken from one point to another. Were you yelling at that?
I was demanding to know who this person was, this man who had grabbed me and was forcing me out of the rally. Yes, I was yelling. And then also, after the two people who followed us into the barn, that was Linda Clary Umberger and Clint Bearden, they both left the barn. And I was, to my knowledge, alone with this man in the barn. And I screamed help at the top of my lungs 6 times, blood-curdling screams.
Hold on. Have you heard that?
Yes, I have.
Hey, when you fit right away. Well, I don't know about this, but we had a pretty good job both of that went right into effect right away.
See, this is
never don't know.
I have had a lot of things happen during speeches.
Is that
Do you recognize that?
Yes, I do.
Is that an audio of the screams that occurred?
Yes.
Is that you screaming?
Yes.
Does that audio accurately reflect your screaming, as you just told us, at the time of this?
Yes.
Judge, I have that on a thumb drive, but it's a section of the thumb drive. I would have to, with your permission or the state's permission, transfer to either a CD, so it's just that. Can I substitute that at some point?
No objection.
If you want to use it in some of the audio files. But those were recorded not by you, but by Mr. Pritchard, correct?
Correct. He, as you know, was not in the barn. He maintained his position in the rally, and there's quite some distance between us.
But that was, in fact, you screaming?
Yes, if you could hear it all the way in the rally. And the audience laughed when they heard my screams.
And in fact, I guess, there's also a video of that. Of the inside of the event with the speaker speaking, correct?
There's an audio of the entire rally, and there are still images that have been cobbled together to create a video, yes, of the rally.
By Mr. Pritch?
Yes, correct.
And you can hear the speaker say weird things happen at political rallies, right?
Yes, and that got a laugh.
Got a laugh from the audience.
Yes.
One moment, please, Judge.
Yes, I will, Mr. Harding.
I'm sorry I'm moving around. I'm going to start with some really boring things. I'm just curious about how long have you had that camera?
Maybe as long as 5 years now.
5 years, so if we go back 2 years, 3 years, is that about right? You operated it many, many times?
I have. Let me restate that. I had a different camera when I started filming, and it was an old high 8 camera, and then I upgraded to a digital camera. So I'm not sure what year, but I've been filming about 5 or 6 years. At some point, I upgraded to a digital camera.
So you went from high, which I guess was a non-digital medium, to a digital medium, is that correct?
To my knowledge, yes, correct.
Okay, now, when you posted your videos and whatnot online, did you drag from directly to your camera, to a hard drive, a desktop? Because some cameras that you can upload wirelessly. How did you get your videos from your camera to your desktop to upload them online?
Insert a USB cable and I download from my camera onto my desktop computer, and then from there I load the files onto YouTube.
Okay, very good. Now, each time you record, how is a file created on your camera? Is it like most cameras? Every time you go to start recording and you stop recording, it creates and labels for you an individual file, correct?
Yes, each clip is an individual file, correct.
Okay, I want to show you something, and it here says Tisdale Video, Greg Edwards. I just want you to look at the file structure here, and I want to see if you recognize it. What I'm showing you is something that I provided Mr. Harvey. I want to see if you agree with me that this is the exact 6 clips that you just put together on YouTube and posted on YouTube. Man, there's a lot of stuff. Okay, let's see how we do here. Take a look at that. 00026 NTS through 00040 NTS. Is that the same labeling that was on your camera when you retrieved from Sheriff's Office?
When I download my files onto my hard drive, it has a date timestamp, and the file name is the year, and then the month, and then the day, and then the time of day. So I don't particularly recognize these numbers, although it might be internal to the camera. I don't actually see that, so I don't really recognize that list of numbers per se. And what's really nice feature is that each clip, from what I see on my desktop when I download it, does give a date timestamp.
Okay, well, let's take a look over the date modified. You see my current cursor is. This looks like it'll be 8/23 of 2014, 3:28 p.m. You agree with me there?
Yes, I do.
Let's take a look on real quick, see what we got. Is that other than this pesky? Does that seem to be correct?
Yes, it does.
Now,
they all have sound, so.
So there should have been sound, is what you're telling me.
Yes.
Okay. Let me see if I can find this sound. Yeah, what I'm doing wrong. I know what I'm doing wrong. I can't really use Abe's excuse just to pin me, but I had to mute it. All right, now. So, one more time, look at 26. Eventually, I'll get both. So, in this instance, which you did not, you actually heard and did not see that time, to create that file, you would have had to start recording and stop recording. create that clip, right?
Right.
All right, so so for instance,
what I did was I just assembled all of the clips that were on my camera and posted them to YouTube. Now, let me clarify. When I first posted it, the pre-shots I had done twice, and so I edited it like I would any normal video that I do, and I just picked, you know, a couple of seconds of the pre-shot. I didn't duplicate it. So it was a shorter 18-minute video on YouTube. And it has about 65,000 views on YouTube. The more recently, I posted all of the entire raw footage, and it is about a 22-minute video. So that video does have all of the footage that was remaining on my camera when it was returned to me after being confiscated by Captain Tony Wooten 6 days later at the Sheriff's Department.
Right. They did give you the camera back, right?
I did get my camera back almost a week later, yes.
Okay, so and there were 6 files, but you're not sure what the names are.
I don't recognize the file names.
Okay, you don't recognize, do you recognize that video?
I recognize the video, yes.
Okay, well, we'll come back to that in a little bit later. Now, you've already helped me understand how your camera creates files by starting and stopping the recording. Now, y'all talking a lot about the advertisement at Burt's on Facebook. Not so much, and I'm just stopping from, not so much from the printed media, but you relied on social media to learn of this event, is that correct?
Yes, that's how I learned about it.
All right, now, it wasn't advertised as Deal's Farm, correct?
No.
Or Purdue's Farm?
No.
Or Olin's Farm?
No.
But it was advertised as Burt's Farm, correct?
Yes, sir.
Right. And you knew that going in, right?
Yes, I knew that going in.
No city of Dawsonville Farm, no county of Dawsonville Farm, correct?
It's located in the city, in the county, but no, it doesn't belong to a governmental agency, correct?
Clearly, it was advertised as Burt's Farm, private property.
It was advertised as Burt's Farm. As far as private property, I didn't research to that extent. I didn't know who owned Burt's Farm.
Oh, okay, well.
I just know that it was known as Burt's Farm. I didn't know who owned it.
Fair enough. There was nothing there that indicated you that the state of Georgia on just the advertisement, that's what I'm talking about, just the listing on Facebook. Nothing that indicated the state of Georgia on that farm, right?
Correct.
Or the city of Dawsonville on that farm, correct?
Correct.
Or the county of Dawson County?
Correct.
And it was located in Dawson County, right?
To my knowledge, yes, it was in Dawson County.
Not in Lumpkin County?
No, not in Lumpkin.
Okay, so it was in Dawson County. Now, on the, you and Mr. Harvey talked a lot about this, the announcement. Hey, what do you call that thing? I mean, what do you, it's an event on Facebook, right?
Yes.
We call it, is that what they use? Because you got all these little things, icons and whatnot on there. It's an event, is that right?
It is a Facebook event, yes.
Okay. It didn't really prohibit anything, did it?
No, it did not.
I mean, it didn't say there's a code of behavior, right? I mean, there's no, this is, it didn't prohibit anything. It didn't tell you had to wear clothing, for example, did it?
Well, our state laws tell us we have to do so. But no, that didn't speak to that.
Fair
Certainly
enough.
Not.
You're right. State laws do say that. It didn't say that you couldn't swear. In front of children, for example. It didn't say that, right?
No.
It didn't say no drinking.
It did not say anything about drinking. It did not address that, no.
And you really didn't say anything at all about what was accepted or what was prohibited or anything like that, did you?
Not on the Facebook event, no.
Now, in the ad that says contact Clint Bearden for more information, you did not contact Clint Bearden, did you?
I did not, no.
And is that because you assumed that you were familiar enough with how these things run? There ain't no sense in contacting Clint Bearden. Or is there a different reason why you didn't?
I had no need of further information, and in fact, I had not seen that ad prior to the event.
Because you didn't even see that ad.
No.
All right, just so I understand, because he showed you a couple. Is the only ad, and I want to make sure I got it right, the only announcement that you saw was the Facebook page, right?
Yes.
All right, so you saw the Facebook page and the Facebook page only, and we all know that it didn't prohibit anything. Now, the Burt's Farm website, did you go to that website prior to actually shooting the farm?
Yes, I went to the website to learn about the venue and to figure out the directions and all pertinent information.
All right. Did it list their operating hours for the year if you were on the website?
I don't recall that detail as far as the operating hours for the year. No, I just knew that the event that I was invited to on Facebook that invited the public was at 3:30 on Saturday, August 23rd, 2014. I didn't have an interest in the rest of the hours the rest of the year, so no, I don't recall that.
Okay, and on their website, did it mention that political rally at all? Did it link to Facebook? Were they linked together, or was it just Burt's Farm? It's the Burt's Farm website.
It was the Burt's Farm website. It wasn't related to the campaign event.
Okay. Now, when you get there, did you see anybody carrying pumpkins around, anything like that?
Carrying pumpkins,
taking pictures of pumpkins, hugging on pumpkins, anything with pumpkins whatsoever?
I believe people were taking pictures of that giant pumpkin, yes, because it was so enormous. It's quite an oddity for people who aren't used to seeing really giant pumpkins.
It was a big pumpkin.
Yes.
There's no disputing that. But I'm saying, did you see like other families out there? Like, were pumpkins set out display for sale in Gorge and other items? Were those goods out for sale for the public when you got there? Do you recall?
I don't know the answer to that. I'm sorry, I don't know. I was invited to have pumpkin pie and pumpkin bread, and that was free. There's no charge for that. I don't know what other products they had or didn't have. I'm sorry, I can't speak to that.
Well, in the area where you ended up, did you see anyone operating a cash register or anything like that?
No, it was a free event and open to the public. There was no charge.
Okay. All right, now, the videos that you saw on YouTube, were they of like families gathered there taking pictures of their kids, doing hay rides, stuff around pumpkins? What were they like? What were the videos that you saw? What was going on at Burt's Farm?
A lot of pumpkins. There was a talking pumpkin. there was a video of the entire Burt's family, in front of the barn. Just a wide variety of different things. And kids climbing pumpkins and just, I mean, everything.
Okay.
Regarding pumpkins and the farm, I presume. And yes, there are a lot of videos online at Burt's Farm.
Were there lots of videos of politicians talking to a bunch of people online at Burt's Farm?
Not to my knowledge. I wasn't looking for that. I was just searching Burt's Farm. I don't know if they've had rallies prior or after this event. I don't know.
Did you just search Burt's Farm?
I just searched Burt Farm and just whatever Google provided to me. I wasn't looking for Burt's Farm political rally or GOP or anything like that. So just a simple Burt's Farm search is all I did.
Understood. Now, it was still that simple search. You didn't get any shows political rally at Burt's Farm or anything like that, right?
Not on the first page of Google, but I mean, it goes tens of thousands of pages. So
sure.
I wasn't looking for that, so I don't know if they existed.
Okay. Now, you guys talked a lot about this too. There were signs on that property, right?
Yes.
And those signs clearly stated Burt's Farm, big green sign on that main barn when you walk up there, right?
I'm not sure that it was green, but yes, a big sign. A big sign that read Burt's Farm, Dawsonville, Georgia. Yes, correct.
All right, and.
And it didn't have a hyphen, so that's why I was confused and said the name Burt's, plural, when there's actually no S at the end of the name. So I misspoke in saying Kathy Burt's a few times when it's actually Kathy Burt.
There's no pronunciation, there's no grammar whatsoever.
There's no punctuation.
I mean, between Dawsonville and Georgia, it's just Dawsonville, GA, right? Now, there was a sign that said no pets allowed, right?
And it was on their guest policy on the website, no pets. And there was also a sign, no pets allowed, as far as I recall, yes.
And it appears to me, from what we've seen thus far, they sold all kinds of things there, right? Commercial things?
I really can't speak to that. I wasn't there to go shopping. I was there to film a public campaign rally that was advertised, come one, come all. So I don't know what wares they sell.
Well, let's slow it down. Let's take a look. See if we can't figure out what all goes on there. Because you testified and stopped me if I'm wrong. You know what they did for it, right? And that means that you would have looked carefully at these signs, right? Is that right?
I'm sorry, repeat the question?
Well, you testified to Mr. Harvey, you knew what they you know, you didn't see anything prohibiting cameras, per se.
Correct. There was no ban on cameras or video cameras.
But so you would look carefully. Now, looks like a green and white sign.
You are correct, it is green, yes, sir.
And you are correct, there's not a lick of punctuation on that thing. It just says Burt's Farm in Dawsonville, Georgia, right?
Yes.
All right, let's see where the other signs we can look at here. Okay, looks like we have all kinds of things going on. Now, on the right-hand side there, it looks like you got, what, pumpkin pie for $8, is that right?
That appears correct, yes.
And a pumpkin roll for $14?
Yes. Right?
And apple bread, $7?
Yes.
If you believe in, it's great for freezing, is that what it says?
Yes, it does.
All right, no pets allowed over there. And am I correct in that they offer, it appears, an entire beauty line of stuff made out of butternut squash?
Early harvest products, yes, there's another sign listing products.
And icy sign beside that, we all know what ices are, right?
I presume I can speak for myself, but yes.
Right, okay, now, there also appears to be some portable signs or movable signs here. Yard signs almost, I would say. Would you agree with that, David?
Yes.
Now, the other signs, you'd agree with, tend to be more fixed. They tend to be more permanent. Is that correct?
Other signs appear to be attached to the building, yes, and more permanent than the campaign signs that we place in a yard.
Okay, now, there is no doubt that this appears to be, at least from what we've captured thus far, and we'll get a little more into this later, a business, correct?
Yes.
All right, so it's because obviously a business that deals with pumpkins, fair enough?
Yes.
Okay, now, should get the right clip here, let's take. I can't control the volume the way I want to, Ms. Tisdale, so I apologize right now. I'm going to try to turn it way down. Let's take a look at this clip. Now, that gentleman right there, is that a logo? If I can get this to work right. On the guy with the camera, and it looked like, you seem to know a lot about cameras. If I get the That appears to be some type of logo, or if I'm mistaken, is that a sticker on that white polo?
The man holding the camera on his arm, I see something on his shirt as well, and I honestly don't know if it's a sticker or an embroidery.
Yeah, it's hard to say, but he seems to be talking with these other gentlemen. You agree with me there around the Purdue bus?
I don't know if they're speaking or not. They're all congregated together, but I don't know if there's conversations between them.
Okay, so, but earlier you testified that these folks were with Mr. Purdue. You knew that for sure?
Well, they all arrived together, and some of them I had recognized from the rally previously in August with that group.
Right, and we can't tell if you talked about, you know, a lot of the computer cameras, you said both take steel and recordings, right?
Yes, correct.
We have no way of knowing whether or not that was even a digital or a film camera, just from that little bit we had right there.
Well, today you can't hardly buy film anymore, get it developed anywhere. I mean, it's pretty obsolete, a film camera.
True enough, but we're surprised to know that I actually take film photographs. I'm a film photograph buff that uses film. I do. It's surprising.
It must be hard to find your product.
Surprisingly not. You'd be amazed how quickly I can get it from Amazon. So we don't know.
Excuse me. To the commentary, please, Judge. Right.
Well, you're surprised, you know, that you can get it very quickly on Amazon.
I have no reaction. It's not something that I searched for. I don't know.
So you don't know whether it would surprise you or not?
I don't shop Amazon that much. I don't know what all they offer.
Is it fair to say you don't have very much experience at all with film technology cameras?
In previous years, yes, I used film cameras quite often, but not anymore that I've switched to digital.
But I mean, currently, right now, like the past 12 months, have you done anything with film?
No, I have not.
So you don't know whether or not film is really easy to get or not, do you?
I haven't searched for it, correct, so
okay.
I don't know.
So now let's see.
But I don't see it in the stores anymore. I don't see the film rolls anywhere.
I understand that, but what you said was it was obsolete, so it informs what an assumption. I almost assumed anything because you have no idea, just like I have no idea, whether that was a digital camera or a film camera.
Did you check to this soliloquy?
No, I've never crossed it.
I know that's not a question.
It is.
What's the relevance?
I'm giving you that. You don't know whether or not that's a digital film or regular.
I have no knowledge of this camera. Right. I didn't inspect it and probably didn't even notice it until I saw it in my video.
Right, but you saw the camera. So, and the point, I guess you got it, there was someone else there with the camera, right?
There were others with cameras, yes, right.
Right. So others with cameras. He very well could have been with Mr. Purdue's campaign. We don't know.
I believe that he was because they got off the bus together. I saw several of them alight from the bus. So I believe that he was with the campaign, but I would have to fact check that.
Okay. Keep going.
Hi, I'm doing great.
I'm Ben Harris.
Old Ben Harris there. Now, he kind of gets you away from the bus there, if you agree with me there. He kind of leads you away. Are you just y'all walking together cordially?
He's not leading me, no.
Okay.
I
take a look at it.
It sounds like he said thanks, yes. I don't know his name.
You've been to a lot of these. The candidates have to have votes for interference for them, right?
I don't know.
You don't know?
I don't know.
You do or you don't?
When I first met candidate David Perdue, I walked into his campaign headquarters and got off the elevator, and the first person I met was Mr. Perdue. And he introduced me to his gun game manager, Billy Kirkland. And I asked, can I film your kickoff rally with that RV bus leaving his campaign headquarters to go across the state of Georgia? Interference? I don't know anything about interference, so I can't speak to it.
Okay, well, let's look at what happened there. You were stopped from approaching the bus, correct?
I was not stopped from approaching the bus. No, incorrect. No one stopped me.
So when he approached you from Ben, I've been whatever his name is, you stopped moving forward. Is that correct?
I was waiting for Mr. Perdue to alight from the bus. I wanted to get my shot. I was standing there so I could film him getting off the bus. That was the shot I was after.
I stayed stationary
so I could get the candidate. That was why I was coming to the bus. And I was filming. No one was stopping my movement or anything or interrupting me. We were having a conversation.
You were having a conversation where you walked over and said, I'm Ben, hey, who are you? Something like that, right? Are you the press? That's the first thing you
And he
to
said,
know.
Are you press? Yes. Right. That was his question.
And then the candidate leaves. And you do get your shot, correct?
I did. I sure did. And my timing was perfect.
And he thanked Ben because Ben's talking to you. We don't know what he thought of thanking him for, but we know he's talking to you and he thanks him because he's talking to you, right?
He did thank the gentleman, yes.
Okay.
I don't know his name, so I can't speak to that.
Well, we don't. We only know what he called him. He called himself, he identified himself as Ben Harris. We just saw that, right?
I didn't actually hear the name, so forgive me.
It's okay. But whatever he identified himself as, and then Mr. Perdue thanked whoever he identified
himself. Certainly, yes.
All right. So we know that. Now, I want to make sure some candidates gave you permission to film. Did I understand your testimony correctly? Is that right?
I had spoken to Mr. Owens when I first arrived.
Right.
And he assumed I would do video recording because that's what I do.
Right.
So yes, the answer to your question is yes, forgive me.
Okay, so Mr. Owens was the one who asked you to speak to.
Well, I'm indicating the Purdue campaign. They were, I guess, checking my credentials, if you will, for lack of a better description, when they asked me, are you press? And I explained that I'm a citizen journalist. I believe I either handed in my card or I said, here, you can take a snapshot of it. I think he took a picture of it because maybe I didn't have an extra card to spare.
All right, then were you recording? You were recording to do this all at the same time?
Yes, my camera, again, has a directional microphone, so it gets the sound in front of the camera and it minimizes the sound behind the camera. So I'm still trying to hold my camera, waiting for Mr. Perdue, and I'm talking behind the camera, yes, correct.
Right, so you're talking to him. You're not looking at the camera. I guess you're looking at whatever he identified himself as. I would say claim it was Ben Harris, but you're looking at Ben, but you're holding the camera over here. Is that what's going on?
I have it in front of me, yes.
All right. Now, where was your identification? Was it around your neck? Was you carrying it in your pocket? Where was it?
I had I don't know how to describe it, a plastic sleeve with a magnet clipped to my dress.
Something like this?
No, it didn't have a leash like that, or whatever
lanyard.
The word is. Lanyard. Thank you for that word.
It was a
clear plastic sleeve, and it had a magnet. And so I clipped the magnet in the front of my sundress that I was wearing that day. So I believe I handed that to him to maybe take a snapshot of it. I'm not exactly sure, but I often will do that. If I don't have a card handy to give, I'll offer them a card just to take a photograph of it for my contact information.
A business card?
My calling card, my business card, my video journalism. It has a picture of my video camera on my card.
All right, so you've got a picture of the camera on the card.
Mm-hmm.
Not a picture of you.
Actually, there is a picture of me on the back side. Yeah.
The back side. All right. Mm-hmm. And driver's license or whatnot, was that in your purse?
My driver's license would be in my purse, yes.
Okay. And when you started filming, when you were filming the speakers, do you remember whether or not you were still wearing the little sleeve magnet apparatus.
I had that identification on, yes, while I was filming. And you see it in several of the pictures. That's the white smile in front of my dress.
It had your name?
It has my name. It has an image of my actual camera, my Sony digital video camera. And it has YouTube and Facebook and Twitter and my website about forcibly.com and my phone number and my email address.
Gotcha.
On one side, and on the back side, it has the iconic photograph taken by Aldo Mahed with the Forsyth Herald of me being escorted out from the coming city council meeting when I tried to film a open to the public meeting, and it was a violation of Georgia State Sunshine Law. So that's on the opposite side.
It's a standard
business one. Yes, standard size
business. Wow. So you get a lot.
On two sides, it's a double sided one.
Yeah, it's
a lot. Well, just the little icons for the different social media sites. It's actually quite simple and straightforward. There's not that much on there.
Okay. I guess. All right, so. You know that you're going to it was built as an old-fashioned meet and greet. Does that sound right?
It was called the Dawsonville Rally. That was the name of the Facebook event, Dawsonville Rally, and that evidence has been submitted to the court.
I need to look at it first. Just gotta look at the board.
It is Facebook.
Yeah.
These three,
Mr. Harvey, I apologize for that. This is the absence. I'm just absent-minded. I am. Okay, so this says Dawsonville Rally, Saturday, August 23rd at 3:30 p.m. Burt's Pumpkin Farm, 5 Burt's Pumpkin Farm Road, Dawsonville, Georgia. Not a whole lot else. I guess some stuff got off. I'm assuming that was.
It has a complete list of candidates. There are a few names that are missing from that screenshot, correct?
All right, now the other ones you didn't see, though. You didn't see the other advertisements. You only saw this one.
Before the rally, yes, sir.
Okay, now. We've gone over, I think it's some detail. It was a public event. And you've been to other. Let me ask you this. Surely you've been to other privately held properties where the public was invited. Owned by somebody else other than a city, county, or state government where the public was invited to come in.
Yes.
You filmed there?
Yes.
Right, now, was it your standing practice to get the permission of the owner of the property before you started filming?
If I knew it to be a private function and not a public function, then yes, I would ask, and actually most people would invite me and ask me to film.
Okay.
I'm not sure if I answered your question, I'm sorry.
If you knew it was private property owned by somebody else, another business, and it's open to the public, is it generally your practice to ask permission of that property owner to film on their property? That's what I'm asking.
Generally my practice to ask permission. If it's an open to the public event and the public is invited and there's no ban on recording video cameras and you have public officials speaking to the public about matters of interest to the public, then no, I wouldn't. Now, if it's like a, there's certain events where you do have to get a press pass in advance, and I have filmed the state Republican Party convention in Athens and in Augusta 2 years in a row, and I did have to get a press pass in advance, and I just had to sign up, and it was there waiting for me when I arrived, and every member of the press has to do so. So it just depends on the venue as to whether or not I have to get formal permission as you described.
It depends on the venue.
And the event, yes.
All right, but so there are, it's fair to say there are certain, whether or not the event is on private property or not, do you consider that at all? Or do you look strictly at whether the public is invited, or how do you judge that? Depending on the venue, do you go strictly by venue rules? Let me ask you that.
I don't know what venue rules are. Okay, I'm not sure. I mean, it would be different for every event, so if there were rules.
Okay, fair enough. Now here, you know you're going on a coffee farm in rural North Georgia, correct?
Yes.
All right. Did you suspect or have any belief that this was publicly held property?
I didn't really think about it.
Okay.
It didn't occur to me who owned the property, the land, if it was private or public. I went, it was an open to the public event. The candidates were speaking, other people were there with cameras. I didn't research the ownership of the land prior to attending an open to the public event.
Okay, I got you. But you know, it said it purported to be Burt's farm.
Yes, it is Burt's farm. I mean, that's the name that appears on the website, and it's a tourist attraction, yes.
Well, it is a tourist attraction, true, but it's also a working farm, right?
I don't know. I don't know the answer to that, I'm sorry.
You don't? Okay.
As far as a working farm growing products or crops, I don't know that.
Well, did you know they sell pumpkins?
Yes, but they may have been grown elsewhere and just, you know, brought in. I don't know. I don't know about their pumpkin business per se. I was there to film a campaign rally. I wasn't there to buy pumpkins.
I understand. But you were going on some other property to do that, right?
Some other property? Other than what?
Other than yours.
Indeed, of course.
Okay.
I wasn't at my house.
Right.
I'm sorry.
So, now, one of the things that you claim over and over again is you got Kathy Burt's permission. Did you seek out Kathy Burt's permission? That's what I want to find out. Did you? Because you kind of tell me that you don't necessarily get permission if the public is invited. But you kept claiming you had Kathy Burt's permission. Is that correct?
That is correct.
Okay, so in this instance, something caused you to seek out and go to Ms. Burt and say, I want permission to film you. Is that what happened?
I introduced myself and she introduced herself. And as I described earlier today, she offered me pumpkin pie and pumpkin bread, and she directed me to the ladies' room. I explained who I am and what I do and that I was going to be filming, and she responded okay. So I had no indication that filming was not welcome or not allowed or barred in any way at all.
Do you recall what you told her exactly?
I don't think anyone can recall exactly, but...
Possibly you told her you were there filming the governor.
Well, the governor was the headliner of the rally. Of course I'm there to film the governor.
No, what I asked is possible you said, I'm here filming the governor. Is it possible you said it like that?
I'm here filming the governor? I am going to film the governor at the rally when he speaks. He was the top of the ticket, as David Perdue was the second candidate listed. They were the co-host of this event, or hosted by Nathan Deal.
So to answer my question, yes, it's possible you stated exactly like that, or no, it's not possible that you stated, I'm here filming the governor.
I said that I will be filming all of the speakers. I mean, I'm going to film the rally. Not just one and not the others. I intended to film all of the candidates and all of the speakers. And I had explained that I had filmed all of the same candidates in the city of Roswell 3 weeks earlier, with the exception of Attorney General Sorrell, since he was not present. And at this rally in Dawsonville, Secretary of State Brian Kemp was absent. So I had filmed all of them previously, and I anticipated filming them again at this time.
Okay. What I want to talk about is the way that you presented the permission that you alleged that you got. Is how you said it. Is it possible you said, I am here filming the governor?
I explained that I was going to film everyone.
So it is possible that you said it exactly like that.
I can't give you an exactly, a word for word. I didn't have my recording going on at that time, so I can't give you exact words. But I did indicate I was going to film everyone that was going to speak on the microphone.
Okay, you told them you were going to be filming, right? You didn't say, may I film here. You said, I am filming these people, correct?
I explained my intention of filming the rally as it was advertised on Facebook. And I explained that I had responded to the Facebook event, I had joined the Facebook event, and I had promulgated the Facebook event by posting it on social media, on Twitter and Facebook, and trying to encourage others to attend the Facebook event, and invited others to join as well, because I thought it was an important event and people, the public, should know about it.
You told Kathy Burt all that.
I did say I promoted the event on social media, and I actually told her I had tagged her or Burt's Farm, Johnny Burt, on Twitter.
You told her all of that.
I explained, yes, that I had promoted the event on social media after I joined the event, and that I had filmed a similar event in Roswell 3 weeks previously.
Okay. But you didn't ask her to be filmed. You were telling her you were going to be filmed. Correct.
I explained what I do and what I expected to be doing there on that day.
Ms. Tisdale, you did not say, may I
answer like 6 times.
No, she hasn't answered it yet.
She has.
What?
Did you ask her, could you film, or did you tell her you would be filming? And let me be specific. Did you say, Ms. Burt, may I film these candidates, or did you just do what you just explained to me you did?
I didn't say, mother, may I, if that's what you're asking. But I did tell her of my intention to film, and that I would be filming, and that's why I have my camera and my camera bag. And I'm not sure if I had my business card with me at that point or not. I don't recall. I often will hand people my business card with my video camera on it and with my information, and I'm not sure if I did that. I often do, but I don't know. I don't recall specifically in that event. But I do wear on my person my calling card in a plastic sleeve, so it's visible, so people can see my name and then see my video camera. So I wasn't hiding my camera. It wasn't surreptitious or clandestine at all. I was very visible, and Mrs. Burt saw me filming. She saw me walking around the property taking pre-shots of the building. There was no objection. Mr. Burt was inside the barn when Mr. Purdue arrived. I filmed him as well. He saw my camera. There was no objection. There was no clue at all that one could not video record the rally.
Okay, now you say he saw, you don't know what he saw or not. You only know that his face turned toward your camera, right?
His eyes were looking at the lens of my camera, yes, right.
Well, or he could have been looking behind your camera, right?
I have some still images that indicate his eyes were trained on the lens of my camera.
At least the area where your lens is, right?
His eyes are looking in the camera. You can see that in the still shots.
Well, they're definitely in the direction of your camera as your camera lens.
Yes, agreed.
Okay, that's what I'm saying. So they're all looking around and looking, and it seems logical they would have seen, correct?
I think everyone saw me with my camera.
Right. And up to this point with the speech stops, no one had bothered or had approached you about stopping the filming, correct?
Can you repeat the question?
No one had approached you about actually not filming up to this point where the speeches start.
Correct.
Okay, correct. Now, you said that on the back of that card, there's an iconic moment. Somebody, and I apologize, that I mentioned was probably a good photo. I've seen this photo, and I know what they did to you. All right, and I think we all agree that was wrong. But you were literally drugged out of, was it City Hall, wasn't it?
City Council chambers in the city of Cumming, yes.
It's identified as City Hall.
City Hall, yes.
And they physically removed you. You had a tripod, didn't you?
Yes.
And you were just filming city business.
Yes.
It was actual business. I mean, I guess similar to a commissioner's meeting, is that correct?
A city council meeting, yes.
Yeah, they vote on things, they talk about things, debate things, correct?
Yes.
Okay, and their decisions actually, I guess, become law or become part of what the city does, correct?
They make a lot of, take a lot of votes, and they're, yes, correct.
Okay, so, and Mr. Owens had filed, I guess, a certain case with it, for their violation of the open records clause, your right to, well, to be exactly what you're doing with
them. May I correct you, the open meetings law?
Open meetings law, yeah. And thank you for that, because I'm merging the two together. I guess the sunshine law is what they're called.
Yes.
All right, and I'm merging the two together. Thank you for that. All right, now, but you also got a settlement out of that, right?
I did. I had a lawsuit separate from the Attorney General's lawsuit, and yes, I settled with the city.
Was it $200,000?
Yes, sir.
That's a large amount of money, you can do that.
Yes, that's a large amount of money.
Okay, now, did you actually discuss the videotaping of the event with anyone specifically prior to driving to Dawson County that day? Do you remember?
Could you repeat the question, please?
Did you discuss filming Burt's farm with anyone prior to actually driving? Have a conversation with somebody, like Mr. Pritchard, for example. Did you talk to him?
I spoke to him at the event when I arrived, prior to the rally being kicked off, but I'm not sure.
Let me clarify. Before the 23rd, like the 22nd or 21st, what few times were actually driving up here, did you talk to anybody about coming up here in Dawson County or anything like that?
I only learned about it on the 22nd.
Oh, okay, so.
So the answer is no to your question, sorry.
Did these other rallies, was there security present that you went to? Did you notice?
Which other rallies?
We talked about one in Roswell. Was there security present?
I don't know.
Where was it held in Roswell? Let me ask you that.
It was outside in the parking lot in off of Highway 92. It was the Fulton County Victory Party campaign headquarters.
Okay.
In Russell.
Okay. Was it just the parking lot their building? Is it just a parking lot or a shopping center? No.
It's an office building, office complex.
Building park. Okay, but you don't know whether or not they had security.
I don't know if they had security. No, I don't know.
There's a lot of candidates were coming.
Candidates were there, yes.
Do you remember what
I do. Governor Deal, Senate candidate David Perdue, Secretary of State Brian Kemp, I believe school superintendent candidate Richard Woods, agricultural candidate, commissioner candidate Gary Black. I may have left one out. Insurance Commission candidate Ralph Hutchins.
You don't recall whether or not there's police officers there or others too?
I don't recall. I don't recall seeing police officers in the uniform. No, I wasn't looking for security. I was looking at the candidates.
Okay. Well, you agree with security's kind of important for the candidates, isn't it?
I can't speak to that. I don't know.
You don't know whether or not the candidates being safe is important or not?
Actually, I think it is important, and I'm sure they, especially the governor, would have some sort of security.
Okay. Now, the guy that sits down, Matt Burgess, the white polo, the deal hat, that talks to you the first time, you want to talk about the video?
I do.
All right. Now, he's dead now.
Yes.
But he was with the governor's office, right?
I don't know if he was with the governor's office or with the state Republican Party, one or the other, or both.
Right, but he clearly asked you to stop filming, correct?
He told me to stop recording or leave because others had been asked to do the same.
Right, now at that moment, just so I don't want to put words in your mouth, I understand what you're trying to say, you believe in being the Republican Party or the governor's office, one of the two, correct?
I thought he was a campaign staffer, but I wasn't certain of which campaign.
Okay.
And actually, I think he did work for both, but I don't know for whom he was working on that day or that rally.
Right, he just had a lot of real deal stuff on that day, is that correct?
He did have a deal for Governor Capt on, yes.
Okay, now. There were a lot of other people present when this had happened, right?
When what happened? I'm sorry.
This whole incident is what it said. When this happened, when you were arrested, there were a lot of people in that area, correct?
There was a good turnout at the rally. There were a lot of people in the area.
And you already testified that you heard laughter there. I think she buffered, said. But you never know. Or something in a political rally. I don't know. I'll try to paraphrase what he said. But you testified that there was laughter while they were dragging you away. Is that right?
No. Okay. That's not right.
Then let's get it right, because I misunderstood what you were saying.
There was laughter at my six screams when I was in the barn.
Oh, okay. On that Fetch Your News audio, that did real hard. Do you remember what he says? Do you recall the joke he says about after doing politics for a while, you get used to anything?
I think he said something to the effect that he's seen a lot of things happen at campaign rallies or something. I'm paraphrasing. I don't exactly remember it. I don't like listening to that.
I understand. And do you recall whether that got a laugh or not?
There was laughter. Yes.
Yeah. You're screaming and there's laughter. And then he makes a slight, it seems to me, of them pulling you away, right?
When you say a slight, I'm sorry, I don't understand.
He makes a statement like that. He says you get used to anything. He tries to, did it look to you like he was trying to use comedic relief to get a laugh? Was it just, what do you think was going on?
I don't know what he was doing, and I didn't hear it because I was in the barn. I can't speak to that. I don't know what his thought process or what he was doing.
Right, but you recall whether they did get a laugh, correct?
There was laughter, yes.
All right, now, all those people there, when this is going on, not one person came to assist you?
Linda Cleary, Umberger, followed me into the barn, and she left afterwards, so she did follow them.
But, I mean, not one person got between Deputy Wooten and you were. Or actually tried to stop your removal from that area, did they?
No.
Now, he had a gun on, right, Deputy Wooten?
In the pictures that I saw later, yes, I saw a gun. I did not see it. I didn't see anything about him prior to being grabbed.
You didn't? Did you realize he was there?
I saw someone walking around with a sidearm, but I didn't know that to be him. And at Republican rallies, that's not uncommon since they passed the gun law, the open carry law.
Okay. was unconfident to have a silver giant star logo with a black polo and a badge on your belt and walk around with your clothes around.
I didn't see the badge, and as far as the logo, I had filmed a Forsyth County Civil Service Board hearing on the Friday before the rally, and there was a retired law enforcement officer who was there who was wearing a logo polo shirt and had a star on it, and he is not in active duty and was not working that day. It's pretty easy to get a logo shirt, and it's not difficult to obtain an embroidered shirt.
Well, I understand, but I'm talking about an embroidered shirt and a firearm and a badge and tactical khakis and boots. I mean, is that common in your experience, to run into folks dressed like that?
Let me object that it seems facts not in evidence.
What's his objection? What's not in evidence? The video is in evidence, what the man's wearing.
Well, it's not. I don't see any guns in there. I don't see any tactical gear. I don't see any badge.
Let's go with dark black shoes. This is defense 21 and 22. He's wearing dark black shoes. Is that a fair statement?
They are black shoes, which is very common to have black shoes.
Right, so we got him a gun, we got black polo, we got a utility belt and black shoes and a logo on the polo. Got all those things he's wearing, right? Right.
He is wearing a black shirt and khaki pants, yes.
And a belt with a gun, correct?
I see the gun in the photo, yes, correct.
And a logo that says Sheriff's Office on the shirt.
In the photos, I saw that, yes.
Okay. Now, you have sued this county for $550,000, correct?
No, sir, I have not sued this county for $550,000.
How much was it?
I did not sue the county.
Who did you sue?
I sued the officers who arrested me.
Did you not give an interlocutory notice to Dawson County?
I did give an interlocutory notice to Dawson County. I did not file a lawsuit against Dawson County.
Okay, so you did not sue Dawson County. You only sued the officers in their individual capacity. Is that correct?
Yes, that is correct.
All right. That's why I'm asking. Now, at any time were both of your hands bound leading up to when you say he takes the camera out of your hand on that video, did he have both of your hands bound when he led you from the tent area? Not the tent area, the board shack? Or the speaker for?
Understood. At any time did he have my hands bound? Yes. When I was against the countertop, he had both of my hands bound.
Okay, prior to him being on the countertop and led you away, did he have both of your hands bound?
No.
Now, what
taking a look at a couple of things.
Hey, I appreciate having you here at Burt's Farm. I think we're ready to get this.
Now, your testimony is that Mr. Beard came up and asked you to cut the recording off as well. Is that right?
Yes.
Now, did he identify himself as Clint Beard? Are you using his name?
No.
All right, so you're saying he didn't say that he was Clint Beard, and you're saying that he didn't tell you that he was the attorney that represented Burt's Farm at all? Is that what your testimony is?
He gave me no information about himself whatsoever. No, he did not identify himself.
And he didn't tell you that the owners have asked that you turn the recording off early?
I'm sorry, repeat the question.
He did not tell you that the owners asked that you turn the recording off early?
No, he did not say that.
Now,
I don't know who was speaking. I don't know who the voice belonged to, but I do know that, yes, as soon as the last person approached and said the property owner doesn't want you to film, it was almost instantaneous that I was grabbed and told, well, you're leaving.
Now, so you never made face-to-face contact with Tony Burchell?
No, he was in my blind side. He was behind me, and that's why I was trying to turn my camera to film him, to try to identify him.
Okay. Well, do you recall him walking around or seeing him walk around to get to you?
No, I don't.
I want to go to and see if you can't help me figure out what made him upset the pattern. That movement in I'm saying 1326 on 1236 on this one. I want to be very specific, okay? I'm going to back it up one more time.
Numbers.
Any idea who that is?
13.
1324. Thank you, Dark.
I'm sorry, I didn't hear what the other sound. I wasn't listening.
Gentle boots, Mr. Tisdale, so I'll blow everybody out of here. 1324.
Man, let's just talk about this latest little bump in the unemployment rate. You know, little Mr. Carter, he is very upset right now about the unemployment rate. He's very.
Do you hear that?
I hear something.
Okay, let's keep going.
Be concerned about the job loss we've seen over the last 3 months. Guess what? He's not telling you the whole.
Well, that's your voice. I distinctly hear having a conversation with someone. Is that correct?
I do hear a voice. I'm not sure. Whose voice is it? It's hard to tell.
Story. Anybody like to guess which private sector has lost jobs over the last 3 months? That's
my private sector. Again, I'm hearing a conversation taking place here. Notice the movement of the camera.
And let me object to the form of that statement, not question. I'm hearing a conversation here.
Strike. I'm hearing a conversation taking place. Is that you talking now? Do you know?
I don't know. And again, at the time, I didn't know there were two people there. So it's hard to tell where the voice is coming from.
All right. Stop at 1351. Well, try to stop at 1351.
But here's the problem. Excuse me. This isn't what's in evidence, and the time frames are different because this is the second one.
I'll get to that. So let's keep watching.
Job loss. The job loss comes from 45,000 jobs lost.
What is your name? What is your name? Sir, what is your name? What is your name, sir? Identify yourself. What is your name?
No.
Okay, so you don't have control of the camera throughout this.
No, I do not have control. Once I get into the barn. I mean, coming from the rally to the barn, yes, I have control, but once I get on the countertop, I lose control.
So is it just sitting on the countertop where that clip ends?
Correct, yes.
So you're not holding it with your hand at all?
No.
Do you take control of it again from where you did you set it down on the countertop? Fall to the countertop? How do you do it?
Captain Wooten grabbed the camera out of my hand and it went down the countertop.
Slide down the countertop.
Slide down the countertop.
And I apologize. I'm talking about when this clip ends. Had the camera gone sliding down the countertop at this point, when the clip I just played?
I'm trying to recall that scene. There's campaign literature. It might be in the next clip. I think I'm still holding it, but you can...
Take a look.
I spoke with several candidates and they didn't mind. I spoke with the owner. I spoke with Kathy Burt. I spoke with Kathy Burt.
Listen, I'm the owner and I said no.
It's hard to say because at one point the camera was wrestled out of my hand, and then I reach and I get it with my other hand, or there's some movement with the camera. So I don't have control like I would when I'm video recording. I've got one arm twisted behind my back and my face planted into a countertop. So it's kind of hard to control my camera when I don't have control of myself.
Understand.
So control, I don't think is an accurate description.
You said that there was a time when there was a transition where you had to grab it with your other hand. Did I hear you correctly?
Yes, he grabbed the camera away from me.
But no, you said, you just testified a thought, that whether or not you had control was a tougher question to answer. Because at one point, the camera, you had to use your other hand or it changed hands. Is that what you just said?
Yes, I believe at some point, the camera was taken out of my hand and I reached for it.
The camera was taken out of your hand and put on the counter?
It slid down the counter.
Okay, but I'm talking about right now. Right now, because I'm trying to figure out how we got to go. Who's holding the camera right now?
I don't know that anyone is necessarily holding it. You see that cord, that black line, that's the cord for the microphone.
Right.
And the lens hood had been grabbed and it flew down the countertop.
Okay.
And so that wire was now in front of the lens, minus the lens hood. And then the camera was grabbed actually three times. And at one point, the camera wasn't in my hand anymore.
Right.
Okay. So this particular image, I can't exactly answer. I don't know.
Mrs. Burt Sutney! Kathy Burt said it was okay. I spoke to her when I first arrived. I spoke with Kathy Burt and she said it was okay.
And then I kind of spoke with you and told your owners, did not want you to do that. You can record all you want, that's fine. And then you resisted. And then you resisted.
Are you the one who moved the camera, I guess, angrily? Other than you?
Well, my body's planted up against the countertop. And my camera bag is close to me, and the camera is there, and so my movements are not my own. I am being forced against this countertop, and so all of this movement may be causing the camera to move.
So, Deputy Wooten was moving you back and forth on the countertop?
He had me slammed up against the countertop, pinned up against it, pushing his body into my body.
All right. And what was he moving you here that caused this to move and turn the camera the way that it turned?
I can't exactly answer that. I don't know. Maybe.
This is some more, and then he fought with me.
I'm sorry, what were you saying?
Maybe when I turned my head to look back at him. I'm not sure. I'm not used to filming with someone having my arm twisted behind my back.
Oh, sure. This is still real well.
I tried to maintain control of it, but.
I didn't fight with you. You're the one who has grabbed me. This was a public event posted up.
No, here, here's a little better. You agree with me, that is your left arm, correct?
I think it's my right arm.
Where's your right arm?
Because my face is planted on the countertop. I'm the same direction as Captain Wooten.
True.
So it looks to be my right arm, possibly.
Does it look in a turn?
Mm-hmm.
It
appears to be my right arm, yes.
Not your left arm.
So at some point the arms change, I think, because when he took me on the rally, it was my left arm.
Okay. So he changed arms on you. And that's when you transition the camera? Because follow me now, if he changed arms on you, and you didn't transition again, you agree with me, your camera would fall on the ground.
No, I was on the countertop. The counter was underneath me.
Oh, I understand that, but you testified.
No, my camera was on the countertop. It didn't fall on the ground. No, it wasn't over the ground. It was over the countertop.
I may be confused, but I thought you testified that he took you out by your left arm because you always filmed with your right arm. I thought that's what you testified to.
That is how he frog marched me out of the rally. Yes, so, my left arm.
So by the time we get here, you're saying that no longer the right arm, the camera is transitioning to your left arm. Correct.
Again, I can't tell if I'm even holding it.
I understand, but you agree with me that that is your right arm.
It appears to be my right arm at that point, yes.
And the camera is definitely not in your right hand.
No, it's not in your right hand.
And thus far, what we looked at, something has moved that camera, correct?
Yes, the forces beyond my control have been moving my body and my camera and my equipment, and I was fearful for my safety and my equipment.
Right, okay, understand. But in somewhere before we get here, the camera has left your right arm that you were filming with, correct?
Yes.
Gone to either your left arm or the counter. You're not sure which. Is that a fair statement?
It's on the counter. I'm sorry. Say the question again.
in his transition, the camera has gone from your right hand to either your left hand or the countertop, correct?
Yes.
Okay.
It's no longer in my right hand at that moment.
Okay.
Facebook by Governor Deal. This was a public event posted on Facebook by Governor Deal. Kathy?
You just talked to the owner who asked you to leave, who's told you you couldn't do this here, and you're still
doing it. Okay, I'll leave.
Oh, you're leaving, now you're going to jail. You resisted me, my lawful duties, trying to get you to cooperate. You didn't want to do that. You fought with me, you wrestled with me, so we're just going to wait, and we're going to go to jail. I don't know what else to do with you. I tried to talk to you, I tried
to explain. Please loosen your grip, I'm not playing anymore.
As soon as you decided to act like you're somebody and stop playing with me.
I'm sorry, sir, what did you say?
As soon as you stop fighting with me,
No, he appears to be actually, if that's your right, he actually appears, am I wrong, that he's a little slightly off center of your right shoulder, is that correct?
Of my right shoulder, my body is twisted around, so I can't tell the alignment. I can't really answer that. I don't know.
Okay. So you testified he was directly behind you. Is that correct?
His crotch was up against my buttocks, yes. He was directly behind me, pushing his body into my body, yes.
I'm not fighting. I'm not resisting you.
And you... You're not now, because I'm not giving you a choice anymore, but you fought me the entire way over here and continued to fight me. I don't know you, I don't know what you have on you, and I don't like it when I tell you to stop doing something and you continue to do it. I don't know what you have in that
I don't know you either. You have not given me your name, sir.
And I'll be happy to. You'll see
it on the floor. And what is your name? Tell me your name, sir, and show me your badge.
You've seen my badge.
No, I haven't, actually.
Yes, you have.
I didn't.
Yes, you have.
You did not see me.
Yes, you have.
Please, sir,
quit. Stop resisting. You keep saying you're being nice for your camera. Stop resisting.
Mrs. Burt, I spoke with her in advance. I told her I was...
All that camera movement right there, Ms. Tisdale, I didn't see a lot of body movement. You're going to tell me. What's going on to move that camera that we just saw? The whole frame changes, all that. It looks like the positioning of the camera. Do you know what's going on in this particular instance?
My camera bag is in front of me on the countertop, and my movement from my upper body just twisting around to respond to Captain Wooten, maybe moving the camera. I think I had it. I mean, I'm not used to filming with my left hand. If I had it in my left hand, it wasn't doing a very good job. I was trying to just record what was going on to have a record of it. But again, there was a lot going on. And I don't know exactly at what point, but Captain Wooten grabbed my camera 3 different times. The first time he grabbed the lens hood, the second time he grabbed the directional microphone, which luckily didn't come off. The lens hood did come off. And the third time, it came off of my hand. There's a strap that goes around my hand, and it was on the counter. And so I tried to reach with it. At some point, the hands, arms chain, I'm not exactly sure, and there appears to be a gap in the footage where the video isn't continuous, and I have no explanation for that.
Well, is it possible buttons were getting hit while all this was going on? I'll just grab it.
Perhaps, but it would be surprising that a button could restart it again. Once it were turned, after it were turned off. I don't know.
Right.
It's a mystery to me.
You agree. We're still not real clear how the camera got to where it is right now and it changed hands.
There was
we
a
know
lot
that it did, right?
Excuse me. There was a lot of jostling going around, yes.
Now, when you were arrested, did they take your other hand? They put both hands behind your back, is that correct?
Yes, that is correct.
Here I was. I have
you just
my camera.
Just have the owner of the place.
Ow! That hurts. You're hurting me.
Stop.
You're hurting me.
Stop.
You are really hurting me.
Stop.
talking about when he's knocked out to the edge of the counter? Is that what you're talking about?
I didn't say edge of the counter. It was on the counter.
Down
the counter.
Down.
Yes. At one point, Captain Wooten turns his head, and you can see it in the video, as if he's looking to see if anyone is around looking. And then, right afterwards, he grabs my camera, and it does release from my hand.
You said did you know that Casey Sanders was walking behind him when he turns and looks there? Did you realize that?
I believe I did see Miss Sanders walking by, yes.
Okay. Were you aware that she was out there behind y'all the entire time this occurred?
Behind us the entire time? No, I did not see her. I had my face planted in the countertop. My long hair was in front of my glasses, and I couldn't see very well.
Yes, ma'am. That was obvious. Okay. But you do recall her now walking past right before he does that. Is that true?
She did walk past the camera, yes.
All right, let's see. Oh, you got it in the big room. And then, okay. Now, all that we've showed was the six clips. Absolutely accurate about what happened there. Are these the six attributes that you put together in one?
Yes, but the last two clips, I expected when I got my camera back to find one continuous longer clip, and there are scenes that are missing. There was other things that went on in between the two clips that are not on the footage, and that's surprising to me why that's not there. I don't understand that.
I understand, but these six, okay, given the location of that camera, did you actually review all of your files prior to Captain Wooten taking it from you to where you knew the number of files that were on your camera?
Oh, I have no idea how many files are on my camera. I don't know. I don't count my files on my camera.
And you had the opportunity, you didn't have the opportunity, did you review any of this? Because, like you said, you were on the camera and you had your hand behind your back, your camera gets knocked out of it. So you couldn't review what video you had from Burt's Farm, could you? Prior to your arrest?
No, I just, from whatever I filmed in the viewfinder, I'm watching what I'm filming. But no, I did not review my footage before my camera was confiscated from me. I'm not sure what your question is if I answered that properly. I'm sorry.
I think you did, and I think it's because it was a really badass question. The way I asked it was really bad. I took compound questions there. And I should have broken it down instead. Did you have an opportunity to review your footage prior to your arrest?
No, sir.
That's how I should ask the question. I'm sorry for that because it was confusing. Now, so you don't know how many clips you actually recorded when you're being arrested, do you?
I wasn't thinking about the number of clips when I was being arrested. No, I did not know, and that thought didn't even occur to me.
Okay. Well, a couple of things. Any more questions? Right now, does any attender in State's Exhibit 1, which are the six clips?
Any objection?
I just don't.
You're good.
Any objection to writing on the chart, right? I'll put a sticker on this, Judge, when the hearing's over. I'll go ahead and move on. Now, at some point there, everything that we just listened to, you tell that you weren't resisting. We're not resisting. You said that.
I was not resisting him. I was just trying not to fall out of my sandals.
claimant fall out of your seat. And I believe you testified, you told Mr. Harvey, you did not fight. Is that true?
I did not fight with him, no.
You didn't kick him, you didn't offer to violence in him anyway.
I did not kick him, I did not do anything, any violence to him in any way, no.
Didn't hit him, didn't resist, is that right?
Correct. I just was trying to protect myself and my camera from damage.
And thank you for your patience. So, no further questions, Jeff.
Thank you, Mr. Greer.
Any further? You may stand down, Ms. Tisdale.
Thank you, Judge Oliver.
Waiting.
Did you want me to bring you something to eat, to drink? But I noticed a sign that said, yeah, not even on the floor. It said, food and drink, yeah, all right.